Hey guys, welcome to One Coin Only. I do apologize, I'm coming to you a little bit late and a little bit sleepy. Long story short, I did have to stay up for the majority of last night for an engagement that didn't end up happening this time, but it will happen next time in regards to our interview with our friends at XBit. So, yeah, I was up all night and I got as much sleep as I could before I came on for the stream. So I am running a little bit late, I do apologize. But we're going to start off the day with some retros. We're going to be doing some Simon's Quest and some Kid Icarus. I haven't done these in a while. I'm looking forward to doing some of my childhood favorites today. And a big shout out to Headlock Gaming for an awesome Mortal Kombat stream before we got started. And thank you so much for coming in and hanging out, guys. On YouTube, we've got Gamer Dad, Punisher James, and Jeremy. And over on the Facebook, we got Kevin there. We got Timmy, Sheba, Dragon. And Giancarlo, good to see you. Thank you for hanging out. We got Ryan in here. We got Chris. Honkus, I should say. When was the last time I called you Ryan, bro? We got Jason. We got Barry, Seth, Vincent, Jordan. And nobody cares. Nobody I care. We got Nick. And we got James there, Thomas, George, Seth. I appreciate you guys very much. Thank you for coming in. Well, let's get this Sunbiz show on the road, hey? We're all ready to go. And my dancing ladies are ready to go as well. They're always ready to go. Hey, go on, Oliver. We got Oliver on YouTube. It's Return of the Champ. Dude, Conker, she missed it last night. But we managed to beat Ivan Frost last night without a single continue. We just did it straight the way through. So I think we're getting better. Hey, go on, Nick. Good to see you. No, wait. No, I'm beating the whole game, Darius. I promise. We're playing a hack too. I'm going to show you how to beat Simon's Quest the easy way. You could beat this game in about an hour and 15 minutes. Maybe it'll take me a bit longer today. So we're playing the NES All-Stars remix of this. It's the same game, but you've got NES characters in here as well. Just to give it a bit of a, you know, Nintendo flavor. So what we're going to do first, the first thing we need to do when we play Simon's Quest is to get the brass knuckles, or the white gem as it's called. And the holy water. But what we need to do is we need to grind for currency for the first 5 minutes. And how you going there, Brett? Nick, thank you very much. Nick, let's start off with you know what, Nick? No worries. Nick, thank you for the 100 stars. This is for you. How you going, Andrew? No, that's okay. When Boonie told you, no, I got you. No, this is a great game. I think this game is misunderstood. This is misunderstood like Sub-Zero Mythologies. No, that's okay. Gareth, you enjoy your nap. You miss playing Simon's Quest. Guys, I haven't been doing a lot of retros lately. I'm kind of at the point where I'm like, you know what? If the retros aren't blowing up as much as the trending games, I don't care. Sometimes I need to play what I love from my childhood. And I know the regulars here enjoy it too. And so sometimes I just need to, if I'm feeling it, I just need to bust these games out, right? Gotta keep myself sane by playing my favorites. Could you imagine that if the movie Pixels had a... You know what? That would be a fantastic idea. I'm actually surprised that it hasn't happened. Hey, go on there, Shawnee. Heather's in here. We got Joseph. I'm not going to forget you. And we got Jessica in the house. Good to see you, Jessica. And we got Steve. And Steve says he's still getting used to catching me on YouTube. Are you getting your notifications, my friend? I guess that's a big question. And, alright, here we go. Nick is dropping the 100 stars. Nick, thank you very much. Nick, this is for you. Thank you so much for the 100 stars. Nick, how you doing today, bud? You all good? How you doing, Chris? Stay real to yourself. Oh, no, it's not about the hate. Well, the only hate is Facebook. That's my problem, mate. It's not got nothing to do with the Sunbish Army. The Sunbish Army is awesome. Did your stars grow through? Guys, if I've missed any stars, let me know. Don't forget, I just asked for a little bit of empathy. Don't forget the chat's going a million miles an hour. And Joseph, thank you very much. Joseph with 100 stars. Joseph, this is for you. Welcome. Left, right, left, I would recommend that you don't send stars for the first minute, 5 minutes when you come in. Because chances are if you do send stars in the first 5 minutes of a stream, I'm going to miss them. Because that's when the chat box is the most chatty, chatty, chatty. So, yeah, I don't mean to be rude, but everything is just going absolutely chaotic. Thank you so much, Joseph. I really appreciate that. Alright, we got to do this. Alright, let's go. And, what's the name of this Simon's Quest Axe? This is called Super Castlevania 2. And it's just basically, yeah, got Nintendo stuff in it, Kid Icarus stuff in it, all that kind of stuff. What we're doing is just trying to grind for money here. And, and Jeremy, what do you mean you don't? You made some art for your friend of 35 years? Well, there you go, Jeremy, good on you. And so we got Jeffrey in here. A big shout out to Jeffrey on YouTube this time. Thank you for coming in, Jeffrey. Jessica, thank you, Jessica, dropping 500 good luck stars. Jess, I'm going to be right with you. You love the leader, Facebook, you love the... It's like that episode of The Simpsons. You know, they're like, you can leave anytime you want. Yeah, but can we? Like, can we really? Can we really leave anytime we want? Jessica, thank you very much for the 500 stars. That's super generous of you. We're going to do this one for you. And also a little bit of dancing, Dwayne. Thank you so much, Jess. I really appreciate you, girl. Thank you for the super donation. Honkers wants a Rick Astley. Honkers dropping 378. Look at this going in hot today, guys. All right, where's Rick? I need to remember where I put Rick. Rick's hiding over here. Rick's... There we go. 21-year-old here that sounds like a 40-year-old. Man, I'd love to have that guy's voice. That would be awesome. Just go around to every girl in the bar and just start singing to her. And she's going to be like, wow, you sound so masculine for your age. And then we go off and make babies and have little Rick Astleys running around all over the house. And we'll live happily ever after. Sounds like a good plan. Anyway, I don't know where I'm going with this. But Honkers, thank you for the stars, brother. You like the sprite of Simon? Wonder how that came about. As I said, this is a hack. How are we going for time? Guys, we just need to chill bang here for another wee minute. Don't forget, guys, I'm just grinding so we can buy this holy water and then we can go to the next part of the game. So, you know, we do have to fuck around for the first 5 minutes, but then it's pretty linear. That guy was... Oh. Got Rickrolled. I love that term. Indy next weekend, so Indy's coming back, eh? You've done that Rick Roll song on the karaoke. Yeah, that is a pretty good karaoke song, isn't it? Oh gosh, I can't sing to save myself. Rick, One Coin Only doesn't do karaoke. I wish I had a singing voice. So what else is going on, guys? How's everyone's Sunday? Did you guys all enjoy the rest of your weekend? Alright guys, we're almost there. David dropping the big 500 stars. Thank you so much, Dave. I'm going to be right with you, sir. And good to see you, Lynn. Lynn, I knew I was forgetting to get back to you. I'm so sorry, Lynn. Nice to see you as well. I'm doing okay. I had to stay up all night, so I'm just trying to catch myself. We're going to do this one. This is going out to you, Dave. Are you not entertained? And also this one. We're going to do epic movies here. Thank you so much, bro, Seth. I really appreciate you. This is Sparta. And, you had to work over 2 hours extra because someone didn't turn up on time. That is freaking annoying when that happens, hey? So, Jeremy says your little nephews and their dad want you to teach them Dungeons & Dragons once a week. Well, there you go, Jeremy. That'll be a fun hobby for both of yous. You sang to a girl at 17 and she rolled you. That's a bummer, isn't it? Conrad says, why did I stay up all night? Well, I was supposed to be interviewed by XBit Gaming at 4:30 in the morning my time. But Jeff ended up having to pull out because of an emergency. So I ended up staying up for no reason. So that's why I'm exceptionally tired right now. But you know, shit happens, guys. It's just one of those things. Show's going to go on. Rick's still going to stream all day. Alright, let's just go this next bit. Oh, I didn't get to do the interview, Kid Jackson, that's what I'm saying. Babom and I need to reschedule. That's okay, I'll let you guys know later. Lee's Castlevania's a nice... Well, I mean, Simon's Quest is. I was actually going to do Castlevania 3 today, and I was just like, there's no way I'm doing a ragey game like... There's no way I'm doing Castlevania 3 off no sleep. So, you know, I was like, Simon's Quest it is. Oh, son of a biscuit, come on. So, well, this is already, if we hit 100 viewers, I think hitting 100 viewers is going to be really, really tough. Playing retro, but I mean, guys, if you want to help us with likes and shares, you never know, we could get there. But, yeah, it's a little bit tricky to get to 100 viewers on a Simon's... I don't remember the last time I got 100 viewers for Simon's Quest, truthfully, but, you know, it's a challenge. How you going, Rodney? Good to see you. No, I mean, but Bomb's a busy guy himself. It wasn't on purpose. I totally forgive him for it. I know he wouldn't do that to me on purpose. So, yeah, we'll just work it out. We'll probably just work it within my hours next time. So, you see what you mean with the Resident Evil 2 remake, and Mr. X is so annoying on there. He is, isn't he? As I said, I prefer the original Resi 2 over Resident Evil 2 Remake, but that's just me. Right, so we're going to save here. Wait, I just said, really? I'm really getting a lot of views today. Well, cover me in butter and call me a freaking crumpet. Holy shit, I had no idea we'd get that many people for Simon's Quest. Thank you. We just hit 100. I don't remember the last time I got 100 people for Simon's Quest. Maybe this is feeling gimmicky and fresh because I haven't done it in a while. Yeah, man, thank you so much. Is that Honkus? Honkus just dropped a big 500. Thank you, Honkus. So Andy says this was your first Castlevania. Thank you, Honkus. What are we going to do, the Honkus? Boom! Big headbutt to the balls. Thank you, Honkus. Honkus dropping the big 500. The OG Resi 2 always. How you going, Anthony? Good to see you. Oh, we're going to try and get... Oh, my gosh. I'm making lots of freaking mistakes here already. Oh, dude! I'm making lots of mistakes today. Lucky I've got my turbo button. That could... you know, it has been a while since I've played Simon's Quest. I need to get my head back in the game. Yeah, thank you so much for coming in, guys. If you're new, welcome to OneCoin. We are a classic and a current gaming stream. We like everything from Mr. D. Wayne's Mortal Kombat stuffs to Super Mario Brothers and everything in between. And alright, there we go, we got this. And did the Honkus just drop another 500 stars, or is that the same one? Oh my gosh, this is crazy. Honkus just dropped another 500. Dude, thank you. Well, what are we going to give to Honkus this time? I don't even know. Let's, we'll give him this one. Thank you so much, brother. Honkus dropping another 500. Appreciate you, sir. You're absolute legend. Oh my goodness. Michael says, Castlevania is usually my bread and butter, but as I said, like, I'm still trying, oh my gosh, dude, like, really? I'm still trying to catch myself here today. Oh, come on, mate! Oh, Jesus, okay. It's alright, we'll get there. Yeah, I'm still trying to catch myself today. You gotta know what a crumpet is to understand cricket, you do. How you going, how you going, Captain BS? Good to see you today. Thank you for coming in. Oh my gosh. The people want an early stream? You mean your people want the early stream? Well, I kind of screwed up because I came on 15 minutes late today. We got Quiet Josh in here. Good to see you, Joshy. Thank you for hanging out. We got Jado. It's a story about a guy named Jado. And he came into the stream 10 minutes late. So one coin's no longer Jado's friend. No, I'm just kidding, Jado. That's rude. Jado, good to see you, man. I hope you're having a great day. I don't know why everything has to be done in the melody of the Brady Bunch, but maybe I need to go watch a marathon on the Brady. You know what? I liked the Brady Bunch as a kid, but I think if I went back and tried to watch the Brady Bunch now, I'd probably want to tear my eyeballs out after watching a few episodes in a row. There's only so many times you can hear, "Oh, Alice." I mean, there's only so many times you can hear that until it's not fucking funny anymore. But, you know, that's okay. Alright, we got this. Honker says, do a damn hot dog. Oh, shit. Alright, here we go. Alright, damn it. I'm a hot dog! I'm a hot dog! Look at me! Look at me! Look at me! You looking? Oh my gosh.
I'm a hot dog.
Holy shit, Honkers, thank you so much. There we go, we finally got the hot dog. Honkers, I have to apologize because what was I gonna say? Have I got the steak yet? No, I need to go back up here. Alright, hold up, wait a minute. Give me a second, guys, just regaining my composure. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, the emojis don't work from my end. So yeah, if I miss an emoji, yeah, I can't see the emojis from my end. Dwayne's a hot dog as well. There's a little bit of hot dog in all of us. So Darius says, please never do that again. Well, I'm sorry, but if someone sends 500 stars or more, they can take my dignity, Darius, by requesting the hot dog dance. Trust me, Darius, I don't like the hot dog dance any more than what you do, Darius. I think the hot dog dance is fucking horrible. But if people ask for it with 500 stars or more, then my hands are tied, bro. All I could do to be a good friend, Darius, is warn you when it's coming so you don't have to watch it. But it's not like I'm doing it for my health, mate. Although it's probably the most cardio I've got in ages. Is Keely Atreus' birthday this week and they're hoping for a show? Oh, there we go. So we got a big shout out to Keely and Atreus. A big shout out to the kids. Guys, it's good to see you. I know it's been a little while since we've had it said hello, but I want to thank you very, very much for always coming in and watching with your mum and dad. I hope you guys are doing fantastic. And I'm hoping I can see you guys when this whole mess is over, hey? Hope you guys are having a good one. And, no, big shout-out to the whole Roth family. And, thank you for everything you guys do. I'm just glad that after all this time, you still enjoy watching this crazy Australian, hey? I'm gonna, it's out, yeah. How you going, Helen? Good to see you. All right, I'm just trying to get back through here. What's the limit gonna be? What's this? How you going? Hey, we got Wes in here. Man, Wes, I haven't seen you in a long time, bud. I hope you're doing absolutely amazing. Thank you for coming in, brother. We are going to have a drink as soon as this whole mess is over and done with, sir. I'm gonna be coming out and I'll be an absolute booze hound, let me tell you. Hope you're doing well. Everyone say a big hello to Wes, one of my real life friends, guys. And, I shouldn't say real life friends. It's bad grammar. What I mean is like my friend behind the scenes. And hey, go on, Mikey. Good to see you. And all right, there we go. Because Honkers, you got two Ricky screens. Yeah, yeah. All right, we made it out of there. That's one. So the first two like mansions in this are the hardest, and then it's pretty much home free. As I said, this game does not go for too long. Could be a boring Christmas. And so Andrew says, do they have hot dogs in Aussie land? And what cop? Yeah, no, we have hot dogs here. I know all you Americans think every Australian lives in the bush and all they're drinking is soup and like singing on a banjo around a campfire before the wallop. I don't know, like, I just want to go inside the head of the average American and think what you think Australia actually is. Because you do realize the majority of Australians live in the big city, just like a California like an LA or a Boston or a Miami. Like, I think there's a big misconception that all Australians are country bumpkins that haven't eaten McDonald's, haven't been to a movie theatre. No, you sumbitch, we're most of us are city folk. You see, you've been watching too many Man from Snowy River videos. I mean, that's part of our culture, but a small part. Do I have hot dogs? Yeah. Oh my gosh. Yeah, hot dogs are made out of dingo meat. Of course they are. Guys, do me a big favor. Please don't forget to like the stream. And as I said, a big thank you for coming. Guys, if I'm missing any comments, just post your comment again. I don't mean to be rude or anything. Oh gosh. And, no, I don't blame you guys, but I just, like, you know, like, when you watch Crocodile Dundee, like, in the 80s, for example, like, I'm pretty sure, I could be mistaken, I don't even remember where, Crocodile Dundee was set. I think it was, like, in Alice Springs or something, or in the Northern Territory, or somewhere really quiet and remote, you know what I mean? Basically, Crocodile Dundee was set in the Outback, and that's just a very small part of the country, guys. It's like, most of us live on the coastline and in big cities and beaches, you know what I mean? Yeah, a lot of Australians are surfer dudes. As I said, most of the big Aussie cities are on the coastline on the beach. That's what I'm saying. And, how you going there, Jared? Good to see you. But no, I don't hold it against you, guys. You can only go by what you see on TV, huh? Like, you know what I mean? If I went by every American that I saw on TV, I'd assume every second of you are on Maury Povich, like, getting a lie detector test or something, you know what I mean? Like, it's the same thing. We're going back over here. I'm only kidding, I was just getting a point across. Nah, but yeah, it's a lovely country here, guys. Like, if you came over here one day when this whole mess is over, you guys would be very, very welcome. How you going, LA Evans? Good to see you. Thank you very much. How you doing today? All Aussies drink Fosters. And then Joseph's trying to say, I still don't know what a biscuit is. So Joseph's in here while I play Simon's Quest, and then he'll probably end up leaving for the next game, because he hates Kid Icarus for some reason. I still never worked out why you hate Kid Icarus, Joseph. And, we going the right way? No, I've got to go across up here first. Do I know any movies that portray Australia properly? That is a very, very, very good question, actually. Obviously, like, Australian-made movies are probably going to... Yeah. But you know, a lot of Australian-made movies play into the Aussie stereotype, come to think of it. You know, exactly, Lynn, you're right. Alright, let me just work this out here. Oh, let me get back to you on that, Seth. That's actually a very, very good question, to be honest. And, yes, I love these two. I haven't done these two for a long, long time, actually. It's been over a month since I've played these games. Probably longer. So, Jeremy says the Outback Steakhouse sells Alice Springs chicken. Yeah, Alice Springs is a central part of the country, and that's where Uluru is, that very famous rock that you may have seen in our country. Jose, thank you for 100 stars. Jose, this is going out to you.
Well, excuse me, princess. Well, excuse me, princess. Well, excuse me.
Thank you so much, Jose. I really, really appreciate you. Thank you for the 100 stars today. And, shout out to Ricky for allowing you a kangaroo drinking at Foster's while listening to Men at Work Starscream. Hey, bro, I do what I have to. I do what I have to contribute to the smiles on people's faces. Man, I don't think I've had this many comments in, like, a half an hour period in ages. As I said, a big thank you, everyone, for coming in. Sorry if I'm a... You haven't seen this one? No, you haven't seen this hack? I've done this hack a fair few times. Alright, we got this here. Alright. And so Jeremy says that now I'm on the big TV. On the one coin only page, it just... No, it doesn't, Michael. Michael, stop making up stuff. Why do you have to make up stuff to sound cool for? How you going there, Marty McFly? Good to see you today. Thank you for hanging out. Oh, gosh. Jeffrey says, just showing some love, Sunbish Army. Absolutely, bro. Sunbish Army for life. Thank you very much, Jeffrey. I'm going to be right with you, sir. What are we going to do here? What are we going to give to Jeffrey? This one. One more time. See, I like the sexy girls. You know, the sexy girls are my favorite screens now. They break up the action perfectly, I think. What do you guys think? The ladies might disagree. Check it out, Rick. I'm not trolling you. You can't send screenshots in the stream. No, you can't send screenshots in the stream. No, you can't. No, you can't send pictures in the stream. No, you can only write comments. Could you imagine if you're allowed to send photos during a stream or pictures and stuff like that? It'd basically be RedTube. I think it's a good idea that trolls aren't allowed to send pictures in the chat. That would be a very, very bad idea. Because you'd see more booty than a freaking Ron Jeremy film. Anyway. You like the dancing ladies? Yeah, dancing ladies are awesome. Jeremy says it's a big anniversary for Back to the Future this year. 35 years, right? Alright, here we go. So let's see how we go here. Hey, go, Mikey. Good to see you. Okay, no worries, Mikey. Yeah, screenshots can be put on the OneCoin page, OneCoin group more specifically. Alright, here we go. This is the second castle. So once this is finally done, the hard part is over. Oh, goodness. So what else is happening, guys? Let me know what you guys have been up to. What's everyone up to tomorrow? Who's back at work? I've had a few people message me lately, tell me that they're finally going back to work tomorrow, so I hope you guys are staying healthy and safe. It's a bit of a jungle out there at the moment. I tell you what, if someone coughs near you, you've got permission to punch them in the nose. And if you get sued, say, well, speak to OneCoin about it. He gave me permission. And you probably shouldn't be encouraging that. you really gotta watch what you say, Rick. You think Lee Thompson actually looks like a dish still? I was never really a big Leah or Leia to whatever, however you say a name. You know, I know who you're talking about, but no, I was never really a big fan of hers. I saw in that movie, like in what was it called? That Eric Stoltz movie. What was it? A Special Kind of Wonderful. And I'm just kind of like, man, I'd be hitting on her friends, not her. You know what I mean? I'm just saying. Alfonso, thank you. You really want a Zig a Zig? Ah, Alfonso with 100 stars. Alfonso, this is for you today. Thank you very much. There you go, Alfonso. The Zig a Zig R today. It's all yours, my friend. As always, OneCoin only leads the world in followers called Jeremy. Yeah, I think OneCoin only. I think the Sunbish Army has more Jeremys and more Davids and more Nicks than any other page in stream history. Hey, guys, we just got Southern Bell Gaming in here going, surprise you, Sunbish. Brittany just dropped a big 1,000 stars. Brittany! Thank you very much, girl. I'm just trying to find your screen now. Let me find where it is. This is for you.
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
Yo!
Keep firing, assholes!
Brittany, thank you so much. Southern Bell Gaming with a big 1,000 stars. And guys, like I said, don't forget to follow her on your travels. And right now, Southern Bell Gaming is... Ah, shit, I went the wrong way. Damn it, now I have to do this all over again. Her cousin's currently streaming on the page until she gets back, so definitely show some support. And alright, let's do this again. I am really, really sorry about that, guys. I'm just all over the place here trying to keep up. Yeah, Spaceballs is awesome. I think how many Spaceball screens have I got? Two at the moment, I think. I need to do a Comb the Desert screen as well. I'm surprised I haven't done that yet. Alright, it's alright. We only have to go back a little bit. We got Big J in the business. Good to see you, Big J. Big J, good to see you. This is Big Rick. Oh, so you ended up streaming tonight. I raided your cousin the other night. I didn't realize it wasn't you, and I was like, oh, Brittany's cousin's on. But yeah, no, I gave you a raid the other night. It was like really early in the morning. We're talking like 3 a.m. or something. Oh, so yeah. So you were around, were you? What was for lunch? I actually just had a can of tin spaghetti for lunch. As I said, I woke up really, really late. So I had to eat something quick and fast. So I just had some tin spaghetti. I had to sleep as much as I could. Because, you know, you guys... I told you guys what happened last night. Oh! So, Davo says you never found this part. Oh, yeah. See, you have to use that gem. Which, see, the thing is, no one could... I could never figure this out as a kid. And no one else could figure this out as a kid either. Without Nintendo Power Magazine. Actually, I think I found that secret passageway totally by accident once upon a time. We're doing it for a shitload of money. Oh, yeah, I know the screen you're talking about with Lone Star. Yeah. That is a good scene, actually. You could easily get 10 star screens out of the Spaceballs movie. I must say I'm a little bit jealous that D-Wayne did the Your Schwartz as Big as Mine screen first. That's like the best scene in the whole freaking movie, and I didn't even think of doing it. Like, idiot Rick. That's I'm sure my parents were very impressed when I was a kid walking around the house saying my Schwartz is... Oh my gosh, the shit that I put my parents through. Yeah, I was a bit of a fucked up kid. It's tin spaghetti. Well, sort of like that. Yes, Johnny. Tin spaghetti's a popular snack in Australia. D-Wayne says you had some Tylenol for breakfast and some water for lunch. And a headache for dinner and just relaxing now. D-Wayne, I hope you're feeling better soon, bro. That tells me you've been overworking, my friend. Before the internet, Nintendo Power was a shiznit. I don't know if you guys remember those Nintendo novels. I keep forgetting what they're called. But if you bought those Nintendo novels, like they have one for Wizards and Warriors, they have one for Simon's Quest. I think if you bought those Nintendo novels, they also had hints for the games as well. I think that's where I learned how to play Simon's Quest. Because I had the Wizards and Warriors and the Simon's Quest book. Did I have any other ones? No, I think they were the only two that I had. Yeah, you too, Lynn. Thank you so much for coming in. Appreciate ya. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Oh, goodness. All right, we're going out of here. All right, so we got that already, didn't we? That's all done. So that's the hardest part of the game over with now, guys. We just need to go all the way to the other side of the map. How you doing, Black Eagle? Good to see you hanging out. Oh, boy. All right, so... Those, as I said, those first two mansions are really finicky, but these last three that we're about to do are, like, all together. So, yeah, like I said, the longest bit of the game's all done already, pretty much. Hey, yo, Marcus, good to see you. Thank you very much for coming in, sir. And how are you keeping today, Dead Tree? You doing alright, mate? We just need to grind one more time at some point, because we... Ah, shit. Alright, let's continue. We need to get enough money for this Whippet Nene on the other side of the map. We need to buy a Morningstar Whip. Give me one second here. Alright, big thank you once again for watching. I can't believe how many people we got in here. I've never ever had... 116 people for Simon's Quest. This is absolutely incredible. Thank you for watching. If you're new here, I just want to remind you guys, we're One Coin Only, and we're a classic and a current gaming stream. We stream every single day from 7 p.m. until late, and we do all sorts of classics, from like Super Mario Brothers to Resident Evil Remake, and just everything in between. And if you like what you see, guys, we'd love to have you follow. Just smash that button. We got Wolven Films on YouTube. Oh boy. So Marcus says you're just dropping in for a like and a share, but no, I understand. You were telling me last night. Congratulations on going back to work, by the way, Marcus. Stay healthy, hey? And we got April in here. How you going, lovely? Thank you for hanging out. Oh boy. And we got Kitty Cat here too. We got EG on YouTube. Good to see you, EG. And we got Terrence. I haven't said a proper hello to Terrence yet, even though I think Terrence has been in here for a while. Good to see you, Terrence. Ugh. Taking a deep breath there, guys. Alright, so we should almost be back to the beginning, hopefully. So, Michael says, whenever you do any Zelda or Castlevania 2, you always watch it live or watch the replay. Well, the next big Zelda 2 stream we got, and I need to touch base with Ian again, but Ian and I are doing a speedrun. We're doing a speedrun competition next month on the 18th, I think. So, yeah, Ian and I are going to be going together one-on-one, and we're going to see who can beat Zelda 2 first. So we're going to have a little competition. It's going to be a lot of fun. Now, I'm a really, really good Zelda 2 player, like probably one of the best on Facebook. But so is Ian, and I think he's going to really give me a run for my money, and I'm very nervous, I'm not going to lie. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting. You know what, that's like, if I had to pick like five of my best games on stream, Zelda 2 would definitely be one of them. And I really don't feel like being humbled next month. Oh gosh, but that'll be cool. So I'll let you guys know when we're closer to it. And that's also going to be a charity stream as well. So, you know, the proceeds we make on that stream, we'll pick a charity as we get closer to the date as well. So, yeah. So, John says you just watched an Australian film recently called Son of a Gun. I've not seen that one. Was it? I mean, it may have been. I don't know what. This is one thing I have to admit about Australia. Look, we've got some great Aussie films, but they're kind of few and far between. Australia is known for great TV series, but the film. A lot of Aussies might hate me saying this, but I feel like the Aussie film industry is really lackluster. I feel like we're known a lot more for our awesome TV than we are for our movies. That's not to say we don't have some all-time classic Australian movies. We got some really, really good ones, but that's not really the norm, truthfully, if I'm going to be completely honest. And it's just a subjective opinion, of course. James dropping the big 100 stars. Thank you once again, James. This is for you. How you going there, Cruz? Good to have you today. Yeah, put that in your diary, April, because it's going to be a very special day, love. Oh, there you go. I sound like an old person saying that. And, we got Sonic Master in here. Good to see you, Sonic Master. Thank you for coming in today. Leroy Jenkins! Okay, I'll do Leroy Jenkins for my next... Whatever the star screen is next, I'll do Leroy Jenkins. This remix is... You like it, Sing? Pretty cool, huh? So, I was too lazy to buy laurels, so I'm probably going to die in here now. That's alright. Cruz, not too much, dude. I'm just doing my record numbers for a Simon's Quest stream today. This is absolutely incredible. I don't know why Simon's Quest is trending all of a sudden, but here we are. So, a big thank you for watching, everybody. I don't understand the Facebook algorithm. They just keep me guessing like some kind of crazy girlfriend, mate. Alright, so we're just gonna go this next area. Yeah, we got the new Mortal Kombat. Well, we film a lot of Hollywood movies in Australia, but they don't count. They're not Australian movies, you know what I mean? Like, a lot of your big Hollywood films, like, for example, like, I know a lot of San Andreas was filmed in Australia and other movies were filmed in Australia. Like, they're still Hollywood movies that were just filmed in Australia. I'm talking about Australian productions, you know what I mean? So, No, we've done some filming of some great Hollywood movies over here, but that's not what I'm talking about today. So Mortal Kombat I class as a Hollywood movie. That's not an Australian movie, you know what I mean? It's a Hollywood movie filmed in Australia, yeah. So yeah, but that you bring up a good point though. Like it can get It takes ages to get the flame whip. We're gonna get the flame whip after this dungeon, I think. It's not Facebook, it's a Sunbish Army sharing. You bring up a good point there, Honkus. We don't want to give them too much credit, do we? Thank you, guys. Again, thank you so much for all the likes and shares. You guys are absolutely incredible. And, Honkus, way to make me feel bad, by the way, Honkus. Honkus dropping a big 100 stars. And Cross-Eyed Bear Gamer has just dropped a very, very, very generous $10 super chat. Cross-Eyed Bear Gamer, thank you very, very much. All right, Honkus and Cross-Eyed Bear Gamer, we got these ones for you today. We're also going to do the Urkel Dance. We haven't done the Urkel Dance in a while. Nick brings up a good point. Nearly anything that involves the end of the world is filmed in Australia. Like, my ex-next-door neighbour was in that movie called The Day the War Began, which was an apocalyptic Aussie movie. So Lincoln Lewis was in that. I own that. He used to be my neighbour. And I spoke to him. Even though I haven't seen him since he was a little kid, he still remembers me. And I just was like, oh, there you go. No, but that was cool. No, so yeah, he's in the Day the War Began. And what was that movie in Perth again when the whole world got eaten up by that big firestorm? What was the name of that movie, Nick? There was that. And then you've got Mad Max, obviously, which is also post-apocalyptic. There's a lot of them. Well, I've got the chain whip right now. We still need to get the Morningstar whip later on. We haven't got the Morningstar whip yet. But yeah, we need to get the Morningstar whip next and turn it into fire. Saying you don't want to be correcting me when it comes to frickin' Simon's Quest, mate, because I've beaten this a million times. So you don't want to be giving me a hard time, mate. There's gonna be trouble. Oh shit balls! There we go. We got him. That was a cool movie, yeah. A cat's gonna go to sleep. No worries, cat. Cat, we'll see you next time. Hey, girl, thank you for hanging out. Oh, shitballs. Well, that sucks. Now we have to do this again. There has been a lot of post-apocalyptic Aussie movies, hasn't there? I mean, you think about it. Like, if you go into the desert, I mean, that looks... yeah. Anyway. Aaron dropping the 200 stars. Aaron, thank you, sir. Shit! Oh my gosh, I have to hang here and grind for enough fuckities. Yes, I have to grind for fuckities today, guys. I need to get enough money to buy a steak. So we need another 36... Oh my gosh, Aaron, this is for you. Thank you, Aaron. Aaron with the big 200 stars. William also says he likes Simon's Quest. William, this is for you.
Tell me you love me. I love you. You gotta do better than that. I love you.
Oh my goodness, you guys are incredible. Thank you for the star love again. We're just gonna get enough gems so we can buy this steak, otherwise we can't complete this level. So this might take me, Is Simon's Quest on Beat It or Eat It? Oh, what's on the menu for Beat It or Eat It this week? A tin spaghetti milkshake. It's disgusting. I've got so many cans of tin spaghetti in the cupboard, I thought, you know, it'd be gross if we made a tin spaghetti milkshake. Oh, the texture's gonna be horrible. So yeah, tin spaghetti milkshake is the punishment for this week. May God have mercy on my soul. How many faculties for a steak? I want a steak. I haven't had a steak in ages. That's one of the first things I'm doing next month once the pub opens back up to 100 people. Invest in an... Speaking of steak, there we go. 50! Yeah, hopefully I win. I really don't feel like doing a tin spaghetti milkshake. The texture and the color of it's going to be disgusting. The NES Kung Fu remix of Mega Man is cool. I've not seen that. There's a Kung Fu remix with Mega Man. Can you tell me where I can get that sing by any chance? I didn't even know that existed. Now, because our crowd here at One Coin Only loves my Kung Fu stream, so to do one with Mega Man would be epic. If you don't have to sing, but if you ever message the page with where I could get it, I would really appreciate that. That'd be awesome. I'm gonna have to remember how to do that. Let me write that down so I don't forget. Kung Fu Mega Man. I'm gonna look for that. I hope I can find that ROM. That'd be epic. Alright, so let's get this. We can finally open this. We got three body parts now. Basically, what we're doing in this game, guys, is we're trying to find five of Dracula's body parts, put them in a pot, stir them together, bring him back into life, only so we can kill him again. Do you know how that makes no freaking sense? We gotta resurrect Dracula in order to kill him. Like, why not just leave him dead to begin with? I don't get it. What am I missing? Video game logic there. Yeah, no, I'll Google search it. Yeah, no, I'm definitely gonna look for that. This is like a Simon's Quest NES crossover. So yeah, there's like Kid Icarus sprites in here. There's like Zelda 2 sprites in here. All sorts of things. Yeah, Beef Stroganoff. I like Beef Stroganoff. I'm gonna go back over here. We only got two more castles after this. Singh says this game takes forever and so much patience. Patience, yes, but when you know what you're doing... Nah, man, piece of cake. Piece of cake, mate! We only got two more mansions left before the final boss. I'm just trying to wait for these sumbitches to move out of the way. Well, that didn't really work out for us, did it? Oh, gosh. Alright, let's go. Oh, there you go. Ash is basically implying that I'm stupid, like, duh, so no one else can resurrect him. Yeah, but why wouldn't you just find his body parts and just destroy them in... I don't get it. I still don't get it. Maybe I'm just stupid. Kid Jackson says you want a nice crispy steak as well. You know what I really, really feel like, Kid Jackson? A steak sandwich, but not one of these horrible steak sandwiches with a tough $2 steak. I'm talking about these steak sandwiches that have a scotch fillet on it. I'd rather pay an extra $5 for a steak sandwich with a scotch fillet on it. It's just tender, it just melts in your mouth, it's awesome. You like your steak, Mooey? Yeah. Anyway, we're going to get out of here. Big thank you once again for watching. Don't forget to smash the like button if you can, guys. It really helps us out today. So, Jeremy says you called the Nintendo hotline to get past the lake in this. Yeah, if you didn't have the novel or Nintendo Power, you would have needed to. Ash has just dropped us a big 1,000 stars. Ash, thank you, my friend. That is incredible. I'm going to be right with you. Give me 1 second to get through this. Thank you, Ash. That's super generous. Any more zeros than that, I'm going to go blind. That's a lot of zeros, my friend. And, alright, there we go. We made it out of here. We can go back. What can we give to Ash today? Alright, let me clear the throat. Leroy Jenkins!
Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins!
Oh my god, he just ran in.
I've never seen a bunch of thirsty and middle-aged women in my whole entire life. That's pretty crazy. Tell you what. You want a hot dog dance? No, if you want the hot dog dance, you have to ask for that beforehand. We don't all need to be seeing the hot dog dance every 2 seconds, boys and girls. Do you like my Leroy Jenkins? I've been working on it. I've been working on it a little bit. So we do have, like, one more grinding spot that we need to take care of here. Don't forget, we need to have enough currency to buy the Morningstar Whip. So what's in here? Is it... No, it's not... Where are we going to go now? That's right, we're just going to get this next jewel. There's Mario. Simon, take this veggie. I need the mushroom back. Well, there we go. We got ourselves a vegetable. Now, don't forget, as soon as we're done with this game, guys, we're coming back straight... we're not going anywhere. We're coming straight on with Kid Icarus. I don't know what we're going to play for our late-night stream yet. I haven't decided. But we'll work it out. And, oh, crap. I've got to go back up here. Just in time. Shit balls. Hate these... Oh, dude, I hate these things. All right, we got him. Leroy, you like the Leroy? Yeah, man. Oh, that was close. I'm hoping we can level up and get our health back before the next, work it out. We're going to be close to leveling up. We've only leveled up once today so far. Is the warp still in this? Damn it! Fuckity fuck 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 fuck! Oh, that's really vulgar language. If you have children in here, I apologize. Oh my gosh. Now I have to start from zero. Ah! Fuck. Alright, sorry everybody. Oh, what was that? You just rounded out with Punisher late? Oh, no, I just did Punisher the other night, Honkus, so I can't do that again for a while. I literally played that like 3 days ago. So, as much as I always love the Punisher, I just picked my nose in front of everyone. It was itchy, I'm sorry. And, as much as I love the Punisher, yeah, I have to wait a little while now. But we'll do it again soon. Terrell's gonna go. No, that's okay. We'll see you next time, man. Thank you very much for hanging out with us today. That's right. So you actually have to burn the curse. Well, that makes sense. That's right, because Simon's cursed in this one. I remember now. Okay, I guess that kind of makes sense. You know, just on pen and paper, it didn't make sense. But when you put some continuity to it, it makes perfect sense. So a big thank you for that, John. Just needed a bit more context, I guess. Singh says you like my accent. Thank you, mate. I've been working hard on it. Have we gone the right... We haven't gone the right way. So, oh wait, no, we got to go back over here and grind. I forgot. What am I doing? Being a stupid head, that's what I'm doing. So we got to grind here until we get 200 gems. F-Zero. I've done F-Zero pretty recently. I'll figure it out, Honkus. I've done F-Zero pretty recently as well. Fucking hell. Alright, hang on. I'll do RoboCop versus Terminator again pretty soon. I'm just not feeling like an exceptionally hard game today. That game busts my balls. So, just gonna wait. Don't thank you, thank Google. Oh, no worries, John. Well, that's all good. Alright, so how many... So, yeah, we need to stay here until we have, yeah. No, that's okay, Honkus. I know you and a lot of other people, sir. I getcha. You know, a lot of people in here are getting back to normality again, like... As I said, I just hope nobody gets sick. I don't need to go the wall yet. I need to get the freaking Morningstar Whip. Fucking hell! Seth! Sing! I need to get the Morningstar Whip still, bro. I haven't got it yet. Which is in the other side of town. Alright, there we go. I'm starting to get really frustrated here at the moment. I don't want to die again before we get this whip, or I'll be really pissed. Alright, we just need... Alright, we've got this. We're just grinding here until we get 200. We're on 116. At least the drops are pretty generous here today. Alright, there we go. As I said, I hate doing these grindy bits, but you do need to do this, you know. It's just unfortunately a necessary evil in this game. You think Late Night Biohazard? I didn't even realize that there was a Resident Evil game on Sega Mega Drive Heat. Is there a Resident Evil game on Mega Drive? I've never heard of it. That's interesting. Jeremy says if you're lucky, maybe you'll get the Chrysogrim. Maybe. You're gonna go to your grave before I level up the... Well, I'm sorry, Seng, but if you don't like my grinding, you know what you can do? You can pack your bags, and you can, like, take the white crystal that I own, and you can teleport out of here, sir. Because you're right now, Seng, right now you are being an impatient sumbish. And, I eat impatient sumbishes here at One Coin Only for breakfast, let me tell you, mate, by cracky. Oh my gosh. Sorry, mate, but I need the currency. What can I fucking do ya? I can't just go into somebody's shop and be like, hey, I want the Morningstar Whip. And the other guy will be like, oh, that's 200 stars. And I'll be like, oh, I'm sorry, I don't have 200 stars. But what I do have is this little mushroom. And the shopkeeper's going to be like, what the fuck am I going to do with this mushroom? And I was going to be like, well, you know what, that's what I said. But Seng said I could come in here and pay for the Morningstar Whip with a mushroom. And then the other person was like, yeah, well, no, come back when you have 200 stars, because Seng was wrong. Anyway. So, yeah, that's my story. Alright, we're almost there, guys. How are we going? We only need another 14. Aaron, thank you again for the 100 stars. That'll help going towards against the whip. Oh, boy, we only need another 8 bucks. You like my grinding? Well, thank you, Joshy. Oh, boy. Desperate time. Oh, gosh. All right, yeah, we're almost there. Come on. We literally just need, like, one more. Oh, now they're not dropping anything. Oh, come on, dude. Don't troll me like this. Hey, go on, Johnny. Good to see you. Aaron just dropped 100 stars, didn't he? It was Aaron, I think. Forgive me if I think I missed that. I think it was Aaron. Now, I'm just going to do a star screen. Let me go back here. And what we got? Let me just double check up here. Aaron, thank you very, very, very much for the 100 stars again, sir. I'm just going to go back in here. What are we going to do for Aaron? Going to go down this way. This one! Thank you for the big 100. There we go. We can finally go buy this whip at Nene now, guys. And then no more grinding, really. Oh, Fari out. Did I just say Fari out? I think I just said Fari out. What the hell does that mean? All right, here we go. The whip's in here. You think we need a finishing pop? Well, sometimes a sumbitch just needs to get his point across, eh? Nothing with Diablo 3 yet. It's not that I haven't wanted to do it, Cruz. I just haven't had time to prepare my character yet. It's just been a combination of not been having a time to... Yeah, it's... As I said, I am going to get back to Diablo 3. I'm not just throwing you in a wild goose chase. We need to get back into it. We'll make it happen. I just feel sorry. I feel bad that it's taken so long, dude. Forgive me. Good morning, Mark. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Alright, guys. We got this. So, yeah. We're just going to go do the Neil trick like Seth said. Truth be told, Seth was correct, but he was just a little bit ahead of himself. So, I keep calling poor Seng Seth. Oh, my goodness. Alright, Seng. What are we going to give to Seng today? Seng, this is for you. Oh, I know this is for Timmy. Shit. What am I doing? Big Timmy with the 200 stars. Thank you, Timmy. Timmy, this one's for you. This is your proper screen.
I have tried drugs. I am broke as shit. I have a judgment against me from some bitch.
Thank you, Timmy. How is your, Oh, my goodness. So, Cross-Eyed Bear Gamer has just dropped a $10 super chat as well. Thank you very much, Benny. Benny says, less shouty. And more spicy. Alright, well, we're going to do some Spice Girls here for you. Thank you, Benny. Well, give me 1 second. Here we go. We'll do some sex. JD has just dropped a $10 super chat as well. Man, you guys are going hard on the YouTube. Thank you so much, JD. Going out to you. We're going to have a little bit of a disco here. And also this one. Big shout out to Cross Eyed Bear Gamer and JD as well. Thank you, guys. That's, as I said, you're spoiling me more than the evil stepchild. You do, what was that movie that Macaulay Culkin was in when he was a kid? Where he was that evil stepchild or whatever? You're spoiling me more than that, sumbish. What was that called again? Stepson. Yeah. You're treating me like a Macaulay Culkin, sumbish. Anyway, ducky ducky down here. The steps, yeah, something like that. That's the one. Jeez, I haven't seen that movie in about 30 years. Goes to show how quick time goes, huh? Oh, it was a good son. That's right. It was the good son. Jeez, that little shit was freaking psycho, wasn't he? What a freaking psycho little turd that guy was. Looks all sweet and innocent like he did in Home Alone, and he just kept, yeah. Fuck that kid. I'm glad he got dropped off a cliff. Anyway, luckily, I better be careful that no one comes in here and listens to that out of context. I could get in big trouble. Which way am I supposed to go? No, we're not going to go this way. How you going, Chris Games a Lot? Thank you very much for coming in. Quincy says, what's on the Beat It or Eat It menu this week? As I said, this week, we are doing Tin Spaghetti Milkshake. Yeah, this is well spotted. This is a hack, Robert. This is Simon's Quest with little sprite changes and stuff. We got Errol in here. Good to see Errol. Sorry, Ricky's called Biohazard Battle. Okay, I don't know that one. This is a hack. Ah, shit. This is a hacky hacky McHackerton, correct. I gotta make sure I'm going the right way on this bad boy, huh? Right, we got this. No, I don't want to throw... Oh, come on, you guys are taking me out of context. Stop that. Jeremy, I'm doing pretty good, man. We're having a good day here. As I said, we're doing some NES classics. Chris says, not picking on you, man, but you think this is the worst one in the Castlevania series? I have 100 people on Facebook right now that would disagree with you, Chris. It's all subjective. I don't think this is the worst game in the Castlevania series. I think this game is misunderstood, to be honest. But, you know, I respect your opinion. This is what I always say to people. I respect your opinion even though you're wrong. And, you know, even though you're wrong, I respect your opinion, Chris. This is definitely not the worst Castlevania game. James says, what time is it? It's 1:30 in the afternoon and it's pretty warm for winter. We're having a warm day. No, Cruz, I'm really, really excited for Diablo 2 Remaster. Cruz, when Diablo 2 Remaster comes out, I am doing that late night every single freaking day. So when Diablo 2 Remaster comes out, that's you and me every evening, Cruz. Cruz, this is for you. Thank you very much once again for the 100 stars. So, Errol says you're never a gamer of the Castlevania series. Never. No, fair enough, man. I mean, Castlevania's not for everyone. And, hey, going, Nick, good to see you there. And says, thanks, loving the Zelda sprites. Marcus just dropped a big 200 stars. Marcus, thank you very much. Is a big grown man in the nappy for you. And also this one, Marcus. Thank you so much for the star love, bro. I really appreciate everything you do for the channel. Glad you're still awake with us as well, my man. Yeah, no, I'm not even just saying that, Cruz. Like, every freaking day. I just want them to make a date announcement on the new Diablo 2 already. We still don't 100% know for sure if that's... I mean, the leaks are from a very reliable source. But we still don't know for sure if Diablo 2 Remastered's coming or if that's still a rumor, you know? So Gene says Diablo 3 is your favorite. I think Diablo 3 is really good, but I don't think it had the same magic as Diablo 2. Like, I think Diablo 2 is a 10 out of 10 game. I think Diablo 3 is an 8 out of 10 game, which is still fantastic. I don't think it had the same magic as Diablo 2, although I think some of the cutscenes in Diablo 3 were pretty incredible. And so Gene says, let's power it up to kill Dracula. Yeah, we're about to get the Flame Whip. We only got one more mansion to go before the boss. And there you go. Gene says, let's power up to kill Dracula. We are. And Honka says, drinking game. Every star drop, take a drink. You guys will be dead within 5 minutes because you're all generous sumbitches. Gene and Honka, thank you guys. And also this one.
Nobody understands cricket. You gotta know what a crumpet is to understand cricket. I'll teach you.
No one will be at... Yeah, I know. Thank you, fellas. Well, Mark just asked me a really good question over on YouTube. Mark just asked me, when am I doing a 24-hour stream again? And the honest answer is, guys, until I can have a vacation and recover some of my energy, I'm not going to be doing another 24-hour stream, because I'm like I'm pushing through, guys, I'm pushing through, but I am running on empty right now, and I'm not going to be able to, like, do a 24-hour stream until I have some recovery time. I am planning on possibly taking a 3-day weekend next month or the month afterwards, so if I can get 3 days where I don't work and just get some rest and recover, then I'll consider doing a 24-hour marathon after that, but, yeah, so, The quick answer to your question is probably not for at least a couple months. I've got to look after my health first. People don't realize how much these marathons take out of you, you know what I mean? Like, I'll do a 24-hour marathon and I'm like absolutely fucked for 2 weeks. Excuse the vulgar language, I just have to get the point across. Yeah, well, we're still a while away from the new Diablo 4 though, Cruz. But Diablo 2 is end of the year, apparently. And drink you some bitches. Honkus with another... Thank you very much, Honkus. Oh my goodness. You guys think this... I still can't believe you guys think this is the worst Castlevania game. Like, that's insulting when you think about all the terrible ones that came out in the original Game Boy, and... No, I think that's very unfair. You can't call this the worst Castlevania game. Well, I mean, you're the stupid ones then for watching, aren't you? Well, maybe you just want to see me suffer in a bad game. It could be that, right? So, Honkus, this is for you. Thank you again, sir. Singh says you love Diablo and your wife, Diana. Or was it Diana? Diana. Diana, isn't it? Diana, Diana. Either way, I'm sure she's lovely, mate. Isn't she lovely? Who sung that song? Didn't Michael Bublé do a version of that? Heath just dropped a beat 530 stars. You guys are going hammer and tongs today. Thank you very much, Heath. This is for you. Heath, thank you so much for the 530 stars, man. Appreciate the love today, you absolute legend. That'll give me some encouragement to get through this balls hard game. It's not that hard, actually. Still appreciate it regardless. If you bag on Zelda 2 for being the worst game, for sure. Well, you know what? Usually I give instant bans for people that pick on Zelda 2. I'm very defensive of Zelda 2, like very, very defensive. I'm probably more defensive of Zelda 2 than any other video game. So Dead Tree says you've been playing a lot of Need for Speed Most Wanted on the PS3. I'd like to go back to that eventually. I've got a copy of that still. We got Back to the Arcade Gaming in here with 100 stars. Thank you so much for coming in. I am doing very well, thank you, my friend. This is for you. Dreams. The song was called Dreams. I've got to remember the artist. Because it's actually been remade a few times. I've got to find the artist for you. The version I played was the late 90s version. And it's what Marco's favorite song. So he started singing it the other day. I thought I'd turn it into a thank you screen. And William says, you forgot the body part. Did I really? Oh, shit. Well, that's okay. We can go back on the way. I forgot the body part. Well, I'm screwed, aren't I? That's all right. We'll go back. Why are you only telling me that now, William? Why are you only telling me that now? Shit.
Ooh, lucky you. You're really in for a treat. I mean, besides me. We're gonna take a look at...
I'm screwing up because I've got so many motherfucking distractions. See, I'm blaming the Sunbish Army. You know, the next time I come on the stream, no one's ever gonna come and watch me because I'm like, fuck you this and fuck you that, and I'm distracted because of you guys. And everyone's gonna be like, well, screw this Aussie asshole. We're never gonna watch him again if he's blaming us for all his freaking mistakes. Yes, I am blaming you for all of life's mistakes today. Oh my gosh. Oh, fantastic, Brandon. Brandon, thank you for the 145 stars. Gonna be right with you. Thank you. Ah, shit. Thank you again, sir. Stevie Wonder did... Was it Stevie Wonder that did the original? I did not know that. I know a lot of Stevie Wonder songs. I didn't realize that was him. There you go. All right, let's just go back through here. Yes, I don't have any laurels. I'm totally aware of this. Now, I'm really struggling to keep up today. I'm so sorry, everybody. Brandon with 145 stars. All right, Brandon, this is for you, sir. Thank you so much for the star, love, man. Really appreciate ya. We are all sumbishes. Ricky, I would love to hear the excuse when the chat is all drunk and the parents ask why we do... Yeah, no, Honkers started you guys on that. That wasn't me. Honkers is the one that made the drinking game. Don't you start blaming me for that. Yeah, that definitely had that 90s synth sound to it, didn't it, Jeremy? Oh, gosh. Elvira's been sexy since you were 5. The first time I remember seeing Elvira, I was about 8 or 9 years old. And, yeah. There was actually an Elvira game on, I think it was on Atari Lynx. I don't know if anyone played it. There was actually an Elvira game on it. I think it was on the Atari Lynx. It could have been a PC game, but I think it was the Atari Lynx. So yeah, there was actually an Elvira video game once upon a time. And, alright. No, it's always good to have you here, Mugen. Thank you so much for coming by. Appreciate you very much, sir. I think we're going the wrong way. Why, who's in here with the same name right now? Oh, we're going back this way. So yeah, we are going to have to go back in the other mansion, guys. I totally screwed this up today. It's not the first time I've done that. But yeah, that is from Blade. It is from Blade. There are two Elvira games. So what system are they on? One's on Atari Lynx, what's the other one on? But yeah, I knew there was at least one of them. Have I ever played Beavis and Butthead? Yeah, but Beavis and Butthead is more of a D-Wayne game. When I was a kid, I used to rent out Beavis and Butthead from the video store. But yeah, I was never very good at it, guys. I beg you, take these stars. Well, there you go. I tell you what, that person was pretty desperate to give me a star donation. I actually never realized that person giving me the stars was a man. I always thought it was like a lady in a burqa or something. I don't know why I always thought that, but apparently that's like an old man in a robe. So I totally got that confused after all these years. Oh, we just gotta beat this sumbitch. Won't be long. So, alright, so we can at least get out of here. Going there late night for game. Yeah, I remember Blockbuster. Man, Blockbuster bought out my old video store. When I was living on the Gold Coast as a kid, they had an awesome video store called Video Flicks. And in 1991, I think it was, Blockbuster bought them out. And, yeah. There's still one left. Yes, we have to go back to the other mansion very, very quickly. That's okay, we got this. Did I forget to get the steak again? Oh, shit. I haven't got the steak. Oh, my God. I am... Oh, my gosh. I really need... Oh, my gosh. I have to come back. I think I just need to go up the stairs to the steak. I don't think it's that far away. We're going to be fine. No, we're good. We just got to go up here and grab it. It's only up around this corner. I remember now. I think it's just around this corner. You think whoever made this hack really likes Mario 2? You think so? I think they liked a lot of different Nintendo games, that's for sure. But yeah, we just have to do a quick detour and get this steak. I forgot it. Oh boy, stay away from me, you skeleton bitch. If you miss a steak, try and get in the hamburger. Thank you very much, D-Wayne. I usually beat this game in about 70 minutes. This is like my slowest playthrough in a long time, but you know, it is what it is. One day I'll show you the easy way to beat this. Invest in an oak steak. Don't mind if I do, thank you very much. I can't afford it yet. Well, how much is it? Fuck, I need another $18. Oh, you're kidding me. Alright, well, we just need to grind down here for a minute. That's fine. Now they're not giving me any gold. There we are. We need $12 to get that steak. Alright, now we need $8. That's fine. Almost there. Just two more drops. Alright, just one more drop. No, two more drops. Shit. Okay. So Singh says I'm too funny. Well, thank you, man. I appreciate that. I'm just being myself for better for worse. Gavin's gonna go to bed. No worries, Gav, we'll see you tomorrow. You take care. Thank you for hanging out, man. It's always good to have you in here. Don't forget to keep smashing those thumbs up if you can, please, everyone. It really, really helps out the channel. We're gonna aim for a like goal of 300 today, because we still got a full game to go after this. And here we go. Alright, so all we need to do is get this... We just need to go all the way back down the bottom. Then we just need to quickly detour back in that last dungeon and we'll be fine. Oh, we can do this. We can do this. We can make it if we try, just as Sambish Army. There we go, we made it out. Fantastic. Currently 100, yeah man, this is incredible. This is really, really good for a retro stream. Like, so thank you so much. Maybe retro's not dead. Man, I mean, if we can keep pushing the retro like this, I'll keep throwing it on. So your birthday warrior out today. Once again, we want to give a big happy birthday to Gavin. Gavin, before you go, we want to give you something a little bit special, my friend. I know it's not a lot, but we want to give you a screaming koala bear, Gavin. I hope you had a good birthday, my friend. Thank you for watching. Robert says, would you play The Guardian Legend? The Guardian Legend is an exceptional game. But I don't know how to play The Guardian Legend properly, so I probably wouldn't do too well, to be honest, Robert. But it's an exceptional game, so good choice. That's probably not really a Rick game, though. How you going, Alexander? Good to see you. Try that fun Castlevania Mario hack. D-Wayne wants to troll me with something. Oh, I'm going to check it out. I've forgotten to have a look at it. I'll have to have a look after. Don't let me forget. Yeah, don't let me forget. Hey, we got Seeker in here. Good to see you, girl. Thank you for hanging out with us. All right, we got to go back this way. Good evening and good morning to you too, Seeker. Thank you for hanging out. So all we need to do is just go in this last mansion, quickly get the item, And then we have the final boss. So we do have a little bit of backtracking, but it's only going to be very quickly. Yeah, thank you for hanging out with us, Seeker. What are you up to today? You're right, that mask was from Mario 2. No worries, Mark. We'll see you next time. Thank you for coming in. And there's only one Blockbuster left in Oregon. And, yeah, you know what? We actually had our Blockbuster in Australia open in Woodridge, which is, like, just 5 minutes from me. And that was open still until just, until just a few years ago, actually. That stayed open for a lot longer. So, I don't know if that was the last one in the country, but it was around for a bit. John says you're terrible. I see, I usually do a lot better at playing this. I'm not having a good day today, but I'm going to try and recover for you all. So we're just going to go back in this... Ah, damn it. Uh-huh. Alright. Oh boy, you guys have been incredibly patient. As I said, we'll be done with this one in about 10 minutes, guys. And then we'll be straight on to Kid Icarus. Kid Icarus is a lot more linear, so it'll be less frustrating to watch. Have I heard of Sonic 06? Yeah, I never played it. I used to own a copy of Sonic 06 back when I was buying and selling games. But I never tried it. I was very close to trying it. I'm glad I didn't. You just go left and right until you game over in this. Well, next time we get a Whatever Wednesday request for Simon's Quest, we can give this to D-Wayne so he can have a turn. It was a Oh, shit. It was a special treat going to Blockbuster as a kid. Oh, dude. Alright, just get out of there, Rick. Yes, I love Blockbuster. I was spoilt a lot as a kid with not only game rentals, but the video store stores where I lived used to always sell a lot of X rentals. So I got spoilt with a lot of X rentals as well. Right, here we go. This is the last mansion, everybody. We just need to quickly go back through here and get that steak. I won't forget this time. The nice Brazilian lady on Street Fighter V with the electricity. What's her name? Laura. Man, bro, she's got the biggest tits on her I've seen in my whole life. I don't mean to be, like, crude, but, dude, there's some big titties, man. Oh my gosh. You know what? You put her on an aeroplane, you save a life jacket if you get my drift. Anyway. What about Cry Little Sister from The Lost Boys? That is a phenomenal. I'd love to do that as a thank you screen. Maybe like the trans version or something. Are we going to get out of here? If you... More baboobies, yes. Was the Castlevania fighting game good? I mean, I personally like Castlevania Judgment. I feel like it makes a better bonus game. Like, I think after you've played it for more than 30 minutes, it'll probably get a bit repetitive in the viewers. But if you're after a bonus game for 30 minutes, I think Castlevania Judgment's pretty sweet. I enjoyed it. I feel like it's pretty fun. No, that's okay. You might be competing against me. I think me, D-Wayne, and Commodore have got a grudge match this week on the GSMW. Oh, damn it, I had the wrong thing on. I'm really having a poor run of this today. There's a lot of excitement going on. Dead Tree says, you're not picky, but you spend more time looking at the Netflix menu than... No, I know what you mean. I'm like that. Because there's just so many choices. It's not about being picky. It's just like, well, what am I going to watch first? Usually I just have to go eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Oh yeah, Castlevania Judgment on the Switch. I'll show you the box afterwards. Yeah, it's called, we just need one more. Okay, there we go. We got enough. Yeah, it's called Castlevania Judgment, and it's on the Nintendo Switch. The Al Bundy screen when he was going to get a new car. I love it when he got, like, that 1 million miles on his Dodge. Yeah, it's pretty good. It got a bad rap, but I actually quite enjoy it. You can set the control. The biggest complaint about the Castlevania fighting game on the Wii was the motion controls weren't responsive. But you can actually change it so it's more based on buttons and motion controls, and it's a lot more playable. Like, how I have my controls set up is I only have the special move set up on the motion controls. My regular attacks are all done with buttons, and I find the game a lot easier to play. So Rami says you're flying to Boston tomorrow to meet your new niece and eat lobster. Rami, thank you for the 100 stars. This is for you. Thank you again, Rami. I really, really appreciate you today, my friend. Oh my gosh, I'm coughing like a sumbish. Right, so all we need to do now is go take on Dracula, guys. We're at the end of the game. We're just going to get out of here. We are almost done, party people. Yeah, I like Cry Little Sister from The Lost Boys. I like, there's so many awesome trance remixes of that song. I think Mario's totally Ron Jeremy. Sticking his mushroom where the sun doesn't shine for money. Okay, that's too much information, Rick. So Jeremy says, do I play Bullet Hell games? No, I can't do Bullet Hell games on stream. That makes no sense, because if I'm trying to read comments and I turn my head, I'm going to blow up with a bullet. I can't do Bullet Hell games while I'm streaming. If I was going to stream a Bullet Hell game for you guys, I wouldn't be able to read any comments. So that ain't going to work out, you know what I mean? Alright, back over me, yeah. Oh, damn. Oh. Yeah, Cry Little Sisters had a lot of trance remixes and stuff. No, I don't enjoy those kind of games in my own time, Jeremy. I'm not a bullet hell kind of guy. I like run and gun shooters, but I'm not good at them. Like, it takes me 60 lives to beat freaking Contra, you know this. Seeker says Brazilian girls have big boobs in general. You think that's... Seeker's all like, speaking from experience, Rick. Yes. Well. Yes, we do find the ladies in Brazil very exotic and beautiful in Australia. I'm not going to deny that. Yeah, there you go. You want some Taylor Swift? You got a Honkus. Honkus with a big 100. I just need to find where I put Tay-Tay, my friend. Alright, where is Taylor Swift? Well, where's Taylor? Tay-Tay. Taylor Swift. Here we go. This is for you, sir. There you go, man. So, yeah, apparently Taylor Swift is really a goat. Oh, wow, that's an interesting combo. I've actually got Dutch heritage. My, well... Yeah, that's basically my family background, too. So, I like my dad's side of the family's, like South African and Dutch. We'll go down here. I'm hoping I'm going the right way. I think this is the right way. We are so close, guys. As I said, thank you for your patience. Sorry this took me a little bit longer than normal today. This is really not the best playthrough in the world. Stars because Adriana Lima is still stupid hot. Well, there you go. Thank you for your 2 cents, Rami, and the stars. I mean, if you're going to give 100 stars, bro, the least I could do is let you have your 2 cents, so... There we have it! Rami, thank you again! Woo! 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 Mugen says, for F's sakes, mate. What did I do, Mugen? Did I do something wrong? I'm always saying something stupid. I'm gonna get cancelled one day. Cancel culture's gonna come and they're gonna be like, Rick, you can't say this, and Rick, you can't say that. And I'm gonna be like, well, I'm sorry, cancel cultured people, but if I wanna say arse and titties on my stream, I'm gonna say arse and titties on my stream, and you're not gonna stop me. Well, Mark Zuckerberg can probably stop me. But yeah, anyway, moving on. Oh my gosh, Onkus, that's gone a bit far, isn't it? Oh, we almost got this. Oh boy. I'm glad you guys have got a sense of humor like me as well, so thank you guys. Yes. Oh, there we go, guys. This is the last area. We are finally there. Well, thank you, Seng. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm sure if your missus was in here and she heard you tell the whole chat about, well, I don't know if she'd be too impressed with that. I don't know. They could go both ways. They could go, yeah, that's an interesting one. I personally wouldn't risk telling the whole chat about what my girlfriend's boobs look like. But I don't have a girlfriend, so I don't have that problem. Oh my gosh, this chat's escalating really quickly today, isn't it? What the hell are we doing? Conrad says, when you're a kid, you never beat this game. We're about to beat this right now, sir. We are almost done. I like the music on the final level. It's perfect. This is my favorite part, too. I think the music's pretty neat. Like, even though all you're doing is walking through a mansion. All right, here he is. Yeah, I heard about that, Davo. Well, thank you, Adam. I don't know. I'll be ready for a girlfriend eventually. Now's not the time, though. There we go. We're just going to burn him to death here. Almost there. Gosh, this is taking a while, isn't it? How many times are you going to hit that sumbish? Alright, guys, we just beat Simon's Quest. Oh my goodness, that door's a mission today. So Seeker says, I would be your girlfriend, Rick. Make you some massages, cook you some Brazilian meals, you would like it. Well, I mean, that's pretty tempting, Seeker. You're already on top of the pecking order. Thank you, girl. It's just one problem, girl. You live on the other side of the world. How am I going to get this massage that you speak of? Joseph wants a hot dog screen. All right, Joseph, I'm going to be right with you. Thank you, man. Joseph wants a hot dog dance. And Honker says, here's 235 stars for ass. Okay. I've created a monster here today on one coin. Alright. But Chris, how you doing, man? Chris also with the big 100 stars. I'm warning you guys that if you don't like the hot dog dance, close your eyes now. Because we're doing a triple hot dog dance for Chris, for Honkus, and for Joseph. So this is going out to you. Ready? I'm a hot dog! I'm a hot dog! Look at me! Look at me! Oh gosh. Seeker says there's a thing called a plane, Rick. Well, yeah. Yeah, there might be planes again once this whole My Sharona garbage is all over and done with. Hey. Hopefully planes will become a thing again. All right, there we go. We got this, guys. All right, so we're going to load up Kid Icarus. Now, I'm going to be doing the same type of hack for Kid Icarus. We're doing Kid Icarus now, guys. Now, this is Kid Icarus NES Land story. This is Kid Icarus also with different NES characters as well. So it's another little hacky stream here. We're going to play this whole game too today, guys. And here we go. Is it, yeah, you close your eyes, but you still heard it. Yes, well, at least I warned you this time. So here you go. This is a, so you can see you've got little turtles in here from Mario Brothers. How you going, Ronald? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. And so Deanna laughs at you saying the word. I know, I'm 39 years old and I still laugh when I say that word. I've got the maturity of a 2-year-old, seriously. Alright, we got this. Alright, we're gonna beat this whole game. As I said, you know, the what's really, really funny about Kid Icarus is when you start this game from scratch, the hardest level in this game is actually, the first world. Once you get past that, the game is very, very straightforward. But the hardest bit of this game has always been the beginning. It always took me so long to beat the beginning of this game. But once I eventually pass the beginning, yeah, guys, once you eventually pass the beginning in this, it's a completely different story. All right, we're gonna save from here. Let me just get these little shitheads. Alright, we got them. Fantastic. Gonna get this last one up here. You think I should speedrun this game? I could probably speedrun Kid Icarus one day. Oh, we got that. Yeah, Turtle Coopers. So we just gotta go over here and get a health pickup too. So D-Wayne says your bed needs a chocolate. Dude, I totally need a chocolate bar too. I'm really, really craving sugar. Although, I ate some sugar last night. I broke my diet last night, so I'm back to eating well again. I break my diet maybe once or twice a week, but for the most part, I'm pretty good. No worries, John. We'll see you next time. Thank you for hanging out. Oh, okay, so that looks like that little thing from, I'm trying to remember what that reminds me of. So at least when you use save states, you can cheat through this bit. Alright, so what's in this one here? Oh, cool. You just got flagged. What'd you get flagged for, Nick? They should make a part with the last part of this. What do you mean? The best part of Kid Icarus is the end, so you'd like to see a Kid Icarus game where you just have the side-scrolling shoot a bit? That's not a bad idea, Sane, because that final level is really, really fun. It's one of the most fun levels in the game, I agree with you. The best chocolate you had was in Belgium. I agree with that. We sell Belgian chocolates in Australia, or that marble chocolate. And, they do the Belgian, in Australia in the supermarkets, you probably get them in the USA. They sell those Belgian seashells. Have you seen those boxes of chocolate that are seashells? And they've just got that, yeah. I love them, man. You probably do them in the US as well. Dead Tree says you won 2 50-pound boxes of Easter candy off and off. Oh my gosh, 50 pounds? Dude, that is insane. You're gonna get the diabetes if you eat that much chocolate. Jesus, 50 pounds of chocolate? I would not trust myself with 50 pounds of chocolate in the house, mate. Seriously. Oh boy. That's, wow. That's incredible. Alright, there we go. We passed the first one. Ah, gotcha, Kid Jackson. I used to love the chocolate ice cream pies. I don't know. I always thought the ice cream... I used to like the ice cream sandwiches when I was a kid. I feel like they always tasted better back then than they do now. I feel like the sandwich part probably just has too much... I don't know. All I'm going to say is I liked the ice cream sandwiches more back in the day. Was that Pac-Man? I don't know, actually. Probably. Oh, I don't even know where half this... Oh, shit. That was close. Alright, let's go over here. Oh, you like Belgian dark chocolate? I've never had the Belgian dark chocolate, just that marble stuff. Oh, dude. Come on, Rick. Stop getting hit, mate. Shit, I'm in big trouble. It's alright, we can hopefully get out of here without getting hit. Let's see how we do. Since we were taught up Netflix earlier, what's a must-watch that may be overlooked? See, that's not just like... That's like asking me the question, what video game... That's like asking me the question what video game you should play. First of all, I don't know what your taste is. I don't know if you like action movies or romantic comedies or dramas or biopics. Like, you know, you asked me that question and I don't know what your taste is. So that's a very difficult question to ask. So Jeremy says it seems to rain a lot here. Go back this way. Joshy dropping the big 100 stars. Thank you again, Joshy. As I said, I can't all thank you enough for being in here today. You guys are absolutely awesome. Giving me a little bit more confidence again with my retro playlist, guys. Cheesecake ice cream. I do like cheesecake ice cream. We're going to go in here. Alright, so we're just going to do this for Josh. Josh, this is for you! Pistachio ice cream is delicious too, isn't it? And I love those shuffling chicks, man. They know how to move. And I don't mean that I don't mean that in a sus way. I just mean like it's cool. I mean, I love the dancing. Not everything is supposed to be sexualized here at One Coin Only. I'm just saying. I'm not that much of a creepo. I'd say on a creepo scale out of 1 to 10, I'm only a 4. I'm not that bad. We're going to go back over here. Oh, we got this. Nick says you love Kid Icarus, never beat it though. Chocolate is so good, Sambishami. We like to party. Nick, you got it, sir. Going out to you once again. We like... Ah, here we go. There you go. That's all I got of that song. We probably should have probably put more of the song in it. But anyway... Nick, thank you very much for the 178 stars. Back of them, yeah. We're gonna go back up, yeah. Just trying to concentrate. As I said, guys, these first couple levels are the hardest in this. But a big thank you for staying up late. We're now officially on One Coin After Dark, guys. And it's always One Coin After Dark when we hit 12 a.m. Eastern on the US. What you want, you got the goods. Well, we might, may as well buy that. They can shuffle on you. Oh, I didn't. I'm sure they can, Luther. I'm sure your missus is gonna love that. She'll probably be like, yeah, nah, Luther, that's not happening. Hey, go on, Raj. Good to see you today. Thank you for hanging out, bro, Seth. Excuse me. I think the hardest bit of this level is the next bit, once we get up to level 1-3, which we're not too far away from. Let's keep going, Rick. You got this. I really, really feel like ice cream now. You guys are, like, really tempting me. I've got to behave. So, Conrad says you're going to go to bed. Oh, no, that's okay, Conrad. Got a new job and have side jobs after work. Good night to you. Thank you, Conrad. We'll see you, good luck with everything. We'll see you next time, dude. That is absolutely no problem. Let me know how you get on. Coldstone is so good. We got a similar company to that over here called Cold Rock. Now, Coldstone is where they take candies and gummies and everything and they bash them into the ice cream, right? That's what Coldstone is, isn't it? Because we have a similar place in Australia called Cold Rock, but they haven't been doing too well. A lot of them have been going out of business. But Cold Rock used to be a big deal, and then I think once the novelty kind of wore off, people stopped eating it. which is a real shame. Technically, it's a new week to break your diet. You bring up a good point. It's a devilish point, but a good point nevertheless. Oh, there we go. Well, we're now a green bish guy. So what happens is we collect those arrows, and then we do extra damage. So they're important. All right, there you go. That's level two done. Yes, I love Baskin and Robbins. Baskin and Robbins is my favorite ice cream. Ben and Jerry's is probably second. So, but no, I love Baskin and Robbins. I always get the three scoop sundae when I go there. And I feel so sick afterwards. So I'm just dying on purpose so we can restart this level with full health. So there's a method to my madness here. Oh, here we go. We got level 1-3 Kid Icarus. We're going to play, as I said, we're going to play this whole game today. Usually only takes me 80 minutes these days to beat Kid Icarus. Very quick. Twix ice cream is... Yeah, D-Wayne taught me the trick of putting a Twix in a coffee. So, yeah, I sometimes now put a Twix in my coffee and it just makes that a little bit extra delicious. So, yeah, you got me onto that trick. A little bit of a life hack. What other food life hacks you got, D-Wayne? Anything else you recommend? Oh, we're gonna keep doing these dungeons, mate. That's alright, we can do it. 1, 2, 3. Waiting for him very patiently. There we go. Alright, it's all straightforward to get out of here now. Now we need to do as many of these hovels as we can. Because the more points we get... Points in this basically act like experience. So the more points you get, the more your health bar goes up. And the more bonus damage arrows you can get. So killing as many enemies in this is really, really, as you can, is really, really important to leveling up your character. Bailey's Irish Cream and... Wow, now that sounds interesting. So putting Bailey's in instead of creamer. That sounds like a fantastic idea. Drinking a coffee and getting drunk at the same time. That's genius. Mind you, Bailey's is actually pretty alcoholic. Like, it's half as alcoholic as regular whiskey, but it's still pretty alcoholic if you think about it, since it tastes so delicious, you know? So, yeah. I've been known to do a few CS Cowboys back in the day. Sounds very, very dirty, I know, but that used to be a popular shot in the Gold Coast. Alright, so which way are we supposed to go? So Seeker loves the old Baileys. Oh, what's in this one? So Pablo says, Ricky, your room is gone. Why did my room go? What did I do? I didn't do nothing. Okay, don't shoot that one, Rick. Old Greg likes Baileys. You should try Stubb Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce. Well, there's a Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce. I do like me some Dr. Pepper. Alright, fantastic. That'll work. And so, Ryan says, gone for 5 minutes, and you're all drunk drinking. I'm thinking of, getting some rum for some coffee. Like, putting rum in coffee... Is pretty delicious too. I don't know if you guys have had rum coffee before, but that's quite nice. They used to do the coffee with rum flavoring at Zarafa's Coffee. I don't know if you guys have got Zarafa's Coffee in the United States, but it's kind of like Starbucks. We got Starbucks here too, but we also got two other big chains. We got Gloria Jean's. And we got Zarafa's Coffee. Zarafa's is actually really on the up. Like, Zarafa's is starting to get those, like, drive-through coffee places, and they're becoming really, really popular over here. Oh, crap. All right, let's just get out. Crown and Coke, you like? Oh, there we go. We got that. You really like tequila and your tequila? As I said, I can't thank you all enough for hanging out. I am going to come back on with a late night, guys. I just don't know what I feel like doing yet, so you'll have to bear with me. Christopher just dropped a big 100 stars. Chris, thank you for the 100 stars today. Chris, this is for you. Appreciate the support, my man. Don't forget, guys, the best way to help us out for free is by giving us a quick like on the stream if you can, guys. It goes a long way. And so, yeah, big thank you if you can do that. Oh, damn. I thought I got the... I probably should have bought something in there, but that's okay. I've got... Oh, crap. I thought I had more health. I'm in big trouble, guys. As I said, this level's probably the hardest in the whole game. Son of a bitch. I don't want to restart this level. I'll try one more time. If I have to restart this level, so be it. I'll try and be more careful next time, but... Oh, stop. Oh my gosh. Oh, dude! Oh my gosh, I'm trying very hard to get out of here. There you go. Fuck off. Oh, come on, just waiting for that sumbitch to piss off. Oh, we're out of here. My gosh, that really sucked. Next time we find a shop, I need to buy another health. I've beaten this game many times without... Ah, god darn it! Beaten this game many times without save states, but I'm a little bit rusty today. Dead Tree says tequila's your weakness. Tequila's one of my weaknesses too, sir. What's your favourite pizza? Yeah, everyone, that's a good question. What's everyone's favourite pizza? My current favourite pizza is a chicken parmigiana pizza. That's a pizza I can get from Aussie. But my favourite pizza is actually the pizza I can get from Thailand, the hot dog pizza at Pizza Company. That's my all-time favourite pizza, but we can't get that here. But James says, if I can get through this game, I deserve my ice cream sandwich. Don't you worry, we're going to beat this game and make it our bitch today. I don't drink much. Like, I had a couple beers to relax last night, which was the first time in weeks. But yeah, I normally, I normally just drink when I'm on vacation. But when I'm on, because I stopped drinking because I used to drink every weekend back when I was a DJ. Like, you know, when you're a DJ, you'd get free drinks every weekend, just get plastered. So I deliberately stopped drinking now unless I'm on vacation. You know, just trying to look after my health a little bit more. Mind you, when I'm on vacation, I drink enough for like 500 weekends. And there we go. Alright, let's try this again. I suck, apparently. Meat lovers or barbecue sauce? I prefer barbecue sauce on my pizza. But when I have the chicken parmigiana pizza, it's the marinara sauce is where it's at. You need to have the marinara sauce for that, but... Generally speaking, on pizza, I prefer barbecue sauce, myself, most of the time. No worries, Jeremy, we'll see you when you get back. Easy, sir. We got the Bubble Bobble characters in this, that's interesting. Oh, did we go the wrong way? I'm totally going the wrong way today, guys. Must have to go up this side. Jeez, it really has been a while since I played this. Fuckity. Really has been a while since I played this, sumbish. Marco dropping 100 stars. Marco, I got your favourite, mate. Marco, thank you so much for the 100 stars. Have you been in here for long? I don't remember saying hello to you this evening yet. No, no worries, Cruz. We'll see you when you come back in. Thank you for hanging out with us. As I said, Cruz, if you're free, I'm going to be back on for a late night. I don't know what I'm doing for the late night yet, but we'll work something out. John says, last time you got drunk was on absinthe and moonshine. And, absinthe, geez, a green fairy they call that, right? Brandon just dropped another big 100 stars as well. Brandon, thank you, sir. Yeah, that's kind of our logic, guys, because we got actually a bunch of free alcohol in the house as well, Dead Tree, because my roommate acquired it for free. And I know exactly what you mean. Now that I've got a lot of alcohol in the house, I don't feel the need to drink it so often. Nick also with 100 stars. You want the hot diggity dog? You got it, Nick. Thank you. Stars are coming in hot today still. This is for you, sir. Thank you very much. Yeah, big love to you too, Nick. You have yourself a great evening. We will see you a little bit later on. As I said, I may do some late night resi. I don't know yet. But I'm feeling some late night resi of some description. Just not sure which game yet. And yeah, take care, Nick. Thank you so much for coming in. Matthew says you can't imagine what a drunk Ricky would look like. It'd be something else. Man, I get pretty wasted. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a bit of a devil when I drink. God have mercy on everyone if you're around me when I'm at a party and I'm drunk. Oh, they used to do a stroganoff pizza. What is really good. But you like almost all kinds of pizza unless the ones with fruits on it. So you don't like pineapple on pizza. I love Hawaiian pizza. See, I sit on the fence. I think Hawaiian pizza is absolutely delicious. I like the pineapple, the ham, and the cheese pizza. I think Hawaiian pizza is great. I do not like pineapple on any other pizza, though. So, the only Hawaiian pizza gets a pass. I think Hawaiian pizza is delicious. Any other pizza, I'm like, nuh-uh. I like thin crust, but, you know, they charge you full price still for a thin crust pizza, and you're not full. I think that's a rip-off. I don't know if you guys have seen the thin crust pizzas at Domino's, but, you know, your meal costs, like, $10, and it weighs all of 150 grams. Like, I feel ripped off. So, and yes, I do measure by weight, because I'm a big boy. I need my food. I like dessert pizzas. They do like a choc banana pizza at this restaurant near where I live, and they do a Nutella calzone too. Dead Tree says you love Hawaiian pizza as well. What is the best crust? I think deep pan. I think when it comes to pizza, like, pizza was made for deep pan. Well, let's get this done. We can do this. Yeah, I think deep pan. Personally. Jeez, we're just keeping him spawn trapped in the corner. Alright, we got it. There you go. That's the hardest level done, guys. This should all be smooth sailing from here. Rick used to be an international Colombiano drug... Oh, don't tell people that. I'll get my Facebook page banned, honkers, and then what am I going to do? Then I'll have to go back to selling smack to underage kids. This is, see, I had this Facebook page, so I don't have to do that anymore. Now, before I'm taken out of context, Mr. Cancel Culture, I am just kidding, I have never sold smack to underage kids, okay? That was just a stupid, stupid comment. Don't ban me for it. Stupid ass band motherfuckers. Alright, there we go. We got this. Alright, cool. No worries, Singh. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time, hey? Really appreciate you, my friend. Hope you have a great evening. Drugs are bad, Mr. Mac and Gary. There we go, we can get our health back. And so Chris is like, that's where we know you from. Yeah, I've been found out, hey? Oh, damn, I totally screwed that up. Give me a sec here, guys. Rico, no, no worries, Rico. Rico just dropped a big 100 stars. Don't mind me, guys. I just had my concentration face on for a second. I think I'm starting to also get a little bit exposed for my lack of sleep. That's alright, we just need to hang tight for a little bit longer. We almost got this. And, so, Black Mugen says thin crust for Domino's. And, so Black Mugen says you get two medium pizzas for, like... Yeah, we do really, really good sales in Australia as well. Like, obviously, if you get pickup in Australia, like, the price of pizza drastically comes down. Rico, thank you again. Rico, what are we going to do for you? Trying to find, where is it? Sexy, here we go, this is for you. This is your favorite.
Rico.
Good night to you too, Sing. You are fortunate, man. Every pot has its lid, and I'm glad you found yours, sir. I'm sure you're a stand-up guy as well, Sing. Alright, back this way. You remember Domino's had a Philly cheesesteak pizza? We still got that in Aussie. Yeah, we still got the Philly cheesesteak pizzas over here. I feel sorry for your mother. Shut the fuck up. That's a bit rude, isn't it? That shopkeeper feels sorry for my mum. Yeah, whatever. Alright, we're gonna go back this way. I kind of loved how, like, innovative this game was. Like, you had your vertical levels, you had your side-scrolling levels, and you had your dungeons, which were free roam. Like, this game was really ahead of its time. Don't forget, this game was made back in, like, 1986. Well, 1986 was when it was published, so this actually was made beforehand. Like, this game is really far ahead of its time. As I said, this will always be one of my favorite NES games. Honka says, wake up, we have a game to win. You can do it all. You can. We can. There we go, we got that sumbish. Thank you, Honkus. Honkus with another 378 stars. We can do it all night long. We can do it just like Lionel, my friend. How cool was that song back in the day? Seriously. I tell you what, Lionel had some pretty cool film clips too. Dancing on the ceiling was a pretty fun one as well. I remember in Australia when I was about 6 or 7 years old, every second commercial was a commercial trying to sell Lionel's new album. I remember that all over the TV. We're gonna go back over here. Piss off, Mario. Jumping around like a sumbish. Wasabi peas are good. Yeah, they sell wasabi peas here. You get the wasabi peas at Asian supermarkets. Yeah, we do the wasabi peas over here too. They're a pretty decent snack. I quite like wasabi peas. They use the dancing in the ceiling in the kid video. Oh, I haven't seen that one. Whatcha want? I got the goods. No, we don't need anything off you, old man, but thank you. Hey, go on, Andy. Good to see you. And guys, thank you for all the shares. I think we're going to make our share goal for today. Oh, shit, I need to reload here. We're going to try and make our share goal today 100, guys, and we are only 26 shares away. So if you know any gaming groups or any people that like retro gaming, tell everyone about OneCoin today. You don't get the wasabi Doritos yet, but you know, you guys in the United States have, like, everything else of everything else, seriously. Like, you guys have usually got 50 flavors of everything. Usually in Australia, we only have 2 flavors of each item. Like, Australian snacks are good, but we're kind of like vanilla ice cream. We only have the basic ones, you know what I mean? Like, for example, we got Pringles over here. And, you know, we'll do, like, the original Pringles, and we'll do, like, the sour cream and chives Pringles, and the salt and vinegar Pringles, and, you know, that's pretty much it. And but you some bitches have got, like, 50 flavors of Pringles, you know what I mean? That kind of deal. The same with sodas, you know, we don't have as many flavors as what you guys have. So, yeah, just thought I'd share that with everybody. Errol says Japan be having the snacks. We've mentioned it before, but you guys need to try yourself a green tea Kit Kat. A green tea Kit Kat or a strawberry Kit Kat. That's what's up. What's in here? I need some health again. Paprika? Oh man, paprika is nice, man. That's a nice flavor. My roommates made some paprika jerky for us before. Alright, here we go, we got this. So I'm going to die on purpose just so I can get my health back for the next level. There you go, that's all done. And Chris says, that's because we're all picky, maybe a little bit. let me just die on purpose here and then we'll restart the stage. Parent says, oh come on, there's going to be only a few things you've only... Not really, dude. I mean, the big thing over here is, like, we've got a lot of different flavors of Tim Tams. So if you guys have, you know, in the United States, you might only be able to find one or two flavors of Tim Tams. Over here, we got about 20 plus. So we do a lot of Tim Tams. Well, I might just have to leave that. Oh, that little freaking munchkin. All right. Fantastic. Is this a hack? Yeah, this is a hack which just replaces stuff with, like, other NES sprites. It's just a nice little fun gimmick. No big deal. We just got back to over 100 viewers, guys. A big welcome if you're new here. And don't forget to smash that follow button. We'd love to see you more often. Do we have a cookies and cream Tim Tam? I can't remember, actually. We got so many flavored Tim Tams, I don't remember, but you know, we got like strawberry, and we got like salted caramel, and we got mint, and we got dark chocolate, and we got the triple chocolate, and we got all sorts of flavors, man. You think the swords look like... Michael, I don't want to know what's on your top drawer, sir. Helen says you can't even get Tim Tams in the US. In the UK, I'm surprised about that. I know UK and Aussie usually share a lot of same snacks, don't they? Apparently, if you live in a major city, you can get Tim Tams from, like, the international aisle in your Walmarts. Because I've had a few people in here tell me that they've gotten Tim Tams from Walmart. You thought the first Tim Tam... We have fish and chips in the UK, which fish and chips is very popular in Australia as well. Very, very popular. And I'm actually dying for fish and chips, actually. I haven't had fish and chips in a while. Let me just double check this. Give me a sec. Gotta be a little bit more careful. Bear with me. Also, there you go. Errol said he ended up having some Tim Tams from the Walmart as well. Yeah, nice. Chris says, you've actually been buying a lot of films that were distributed in Australia, but are no longer available for print in the United States. Oh, what kind of films are we talking, my friend? I just had one of my, like, spaced out moments, guys. As I said, I was up until about 6 in the morning. So, there you go. I'm actually surprised I'm functioning today. I used to do this all the time. I remember when I was still a DJ, I'd go to bed at 6 in the morning and I'd wake up at this time for a stream. I don't know how I used to do that every weekend, man. It seems like such a distant memory now, being a nightclub DJ. It's been over a year. I miss playing music for people sometimes, but, yeah, you know, gotta evolve. Maybe one day I can do one, like a special DJ gig or something. So Edmund says you do beer, fish and chips. Yeah, well, we like beer battered chips here in Australia. Eth says the worst ever game you played was E.T. on Atari. I think E.T. is a very, very bad game. I don't think it's the worst game I've ever played. I feel like the problem with E.T. is it doesn't necessarily make sense what you're supposed to do. Shit. Yeah, it doesn't always make sense what you're supposed to do. I feel sorry for your mother. Thank you very much for that. Jeremy says you're back, you had some tuna salad and your nightly medicine. Well, there you go, Jeremy. Thank you for that. Oh, nice. I love Young Guns 2. I've actually got a Young Guns 2 thank you screen. I just don't have it loaded right now. But I'm a big Young Guns guy. I've always loved Young Guns. I like the second movie, I think, better than the first. But they're both pretty good. Anyone else in here like Young Guns? Damn, man. I tell you what, Emilio Estevez was freaking awesome back in the day, hey? And welcome back, Cruz. You're playing PlayStation, watching the stream at the same time. Thank you for that. As I said, I encourage you guys to multitask. Like, D-Wayne's usually working and watching me at the same time. I'm like that when I watch streams too. Man, when you're as busy as us, you learn how to multitask. And we can be like freaking Jemima on the telephone. You know, I always tell you about Jemima. Jemima's always that mum that's in the kitchen that's cooking. She's got the saucepan in one hand. She's got the baby in the other hand. She's opening the oven with her foot. And then she's talking to Deborah on the phone between her chin and her shoulder. You know, like, I'm slowly learning how to multitask like that. It's not easy. But, you know, I'm trying to become more skilled. Oh, gosh. So, yeah. John says he's usually multitasking as well. No, I feel you. So, Heath says, what is the worst game that I've played on Atari? Oh, dude, it's probably Custer's Revenge, to be honest. I think Custer's Revenge is really, really tasteless. And, like, I'm all about, like, you know, having an open mind and everything, but there's no redeeming qualities about Custer's Revenge. That shouldn't have ever been allowed to print, to be honest. So, I think the worst Atari game's Custer's Revenge. I've got to take issue with that. So, yeah. Do you have to enter every cave? No, but I like to. As I said, the more points you earn, the more abilities you can gain. So it's good to check everything, you know. Sorry if going in every cave is annoying. It's just, you know, it's just OCD in me. I think we're almost out of here. Have I played World of Tanks? No, I haven't played World of Tanks yet. I still gotta. Does anyone actually stream World of Tanks? Are there any World of Tanks streamers out there? I'm kinda curious. So guys, I'm just gonna die on purpose and get my health back for this level again. So just bear with me here. We almost got the hardest part of this game over. Once we're on level 3, the end of this game's pretty quick. Sings back, we get it, bro, you love your wife. Good to see you back, Sing. Big shout out to Diana once again. How you going there, Steven? Good to see you. We got Rodney in here. Yeah, he says you forgot about Custer's revenge. Yeah, it was... Well, I mean, he got his comeuppance anyway, didn't he? And, we got this. Alright, we got this. Alright, what do we got over here? Alright, we're gonna enter this. There you go. Don't mind me, guys. Let's have my concentration face back. He's always in that middle one! I freaking knew it. Back over here. Yeah, so Ricky D Twitch, if you want a private message, just... Oh, no, sure, man. Absolutely. I'd love to see how they go. Yeah, I was just always curious. Oh, no, the Cowboy and Indian game was Gunsmoke. Gunsmoke's a good game. Gunsmoke's a mighty fine game, actually. That's one of the better NES games. It's in my top 50. I wouldn't go as far as, say, top 10 or 20, but it's in my top 50 NES games. Keep in mind, the NES has got at least 200 decent games, so... But being in the top 50 is not that big, you know, it's a big deal. You know, there's a library of, like, about 714 NES games, I think. Probably 200 of them are decent. Maybe not quite 200, maybe 100 or 150, but, you know, a lot. So let's see what's in here. So, Dead Tree says you played a few 2600 games that you couldn't figure out how to play. So there was a highly acclaimed Atari 2600 game called Raiders of the Lost Ark, and I could never figure out what I was doing in that. The other one was Adventure. Apparently there was a big video game magazine in the 80s, and if you could be the first person to beat Adventure, you'd get this jewel-encrusted sword, I think, worth $250,000 American or something. It was a pretty big deal. When video games first came out, they were made out to be the biggest deal ever. So what are we going to do here? We got this. As I said, Singh, I'm happy for you, brother. I'm not telling you not to love your wife. All I'm saying, Singh, is I think we're not going to forget because you've told us enough. I just think because, most big major publishers are publicly traded companies now, they're playing it safe for their shareholders, and they're not trying to push any boundaries. That's why I'm so grateful for Steam, because on Steam now, you've got so many independent developers just making awesome games, and they're kind of pulling up the slack where the AAA companies aren't, I think. Oh, good on you, Heath. Yeah, we love Street Fighter on the channel, man. I do a lot of Street Fighter streams here. We do Street Fighter 5 at least once a week. Next time I do a Street Fighter stream, I'm going to do the 30th Anniversary Collection again. We'll find some cool characters to use. Wild Guns coming to the PS... So, oh, wait, there's a Wild Guns coming to PS4? I remember that. That'll be cool. Alright, we're gonna go in this sumbish. What's in here this time? Oh, another one of these sumbishes. Seriously? As I said, if we don't forget to do every single one of these dungeons, it's gonna be worth it. We're probably gonna get another arrow, which will give us more attack damage. You love your 1-Up arcade? What 1-Up arcade you got again? Oh, we got it. You never had any... wait, so Wild Guns and Wild... What's the other one? Wild Arms. Wild Guns, no. I've got the remake of Wild Guns. Sorry, I get Wild Arms and Wild Guns confused. Wild Guns is that cowboy rail shooter, right? No, I've got that game, and I'd love to stream it one day, and I actually tried, But I can't play that game to save myself. It's really tough. No, that's a cool game. I'm just going to pick this up over here. There's a Custer's Revenge remake. Really not interested in that game. That's just, could you imagine if that game came out in 2020? Jesus, mate. Fucking hell. You would request it for whatever Wednesday. Which game was that again? Michael, can you tell me what game that is again? Wild Arms? No, Wild Arms would get more than 5 minutes. You'd probably get 10 minutes out of Wild Arms. Which is better than a kick in the head. Almost out of here, guys. Hanging in there. Like we really need monkeys falling out of the sky. Seriously. Gunstar Heroes is a pretty quick game. Gunstar Heroes takes about 70 or 80 minutes to beat. The Gunstar Heroes is one of those games that's longer than what it seems, actually. I'm a big fan of Gunstar Heroes. I like to play that quite often. Alright, guys. We made it. We're up to this dungeon. Yeah, I know the difference between all of them. I just get them both confused. Oh, alright, let's go in here. Yeah, it's in real poor taste, man. Good night to you too, Andy. We'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. As I said, guys, I'm gonna have a break and come back on with a late night stream after this. I just don't know what I'm streaming yet. I feel like shooting some zombies, so I might pull out one of my zombie shooters on the Nintendo Wii, but we'll see how we go. Captain BS says, keep it up, man, you got this. I hope so. Thank you very much, Captain BS. I'm trying, mate. Captain BS just dropped a big $2 super chat. That nearly... Told you I'm sleepy. That nearly went way over my head. Captain BS, thank you, brother. This one's for you. I'm glad you're enjoying the stream, bud. How are you doing today, by the way, Captain BS? What's going on your end? Everything okay? We're gonna... Almost out of here. See, we got Goombas in here and everything. That's pretty cool. Oh, boy. One thing I do like about Kid Icarus is he does have a lot of hang time if you need to jump anywhere. If you got Blood Rain, you can kill... I think Once Upon a Time... Retro Y actually streamed that game for us on our channel back in the day. I could be wrong. Marcus says, can you get some dance music in your headphones at work? You got it, Marcus. Marcus is dropping the big 500 stars. And we have a little bit of a dance party for you, sir. Thank you so much, Marcus. Marcus of the Big 500. I hope that hyped you up a little bit, sir. Oh, I wish I could... I always wished I could play those thank you screens for a little bit longer, but, you know, the record companies would basically... I was about to use a really horrible analogy then, but you get the drift. Oh, gosh. Packing up to move in a few days, so it's going... How far... Oh, really? Is that for, like, back on campus, you mean? Or are you moving into a different house altogether, Captain BS? How far do you have to go? As I said, I'm going to be making some more shuffling videos very, very soon. You just reminded me I need to make some more thank you screens tonight as well. Yeah, I'll probably make another 5 or 6 tonight after my next stream. Jeez, I'm a busy sumbish today. What you want. Don't really need anything right now. Timmy dropping a big 100 stars as well. Thank you so much, Timmy. What are we going to give to Timmy today? Let's have a look here. This one. Oh, yeah!
You're going nowhere. I got you for 3 minutes. 3 minutes of pee time.
Good to see you still in here, Timmy. Thank you so much. Timmy with the big 100 guys. And, yeah, so after we do this dungeon, guys, we're up to world 3, which has got 4 levels, and then the 4th world has only got 1 level, so we're well over halfway now. And the good news is the next, level 3 is actually quite basic. Oh, I hate Mr. Fucking Eggplant. Oh, I hate being an eggplant! One, no, stop it, I don't want to be an eggplant! Not being no freaking eggplant today, you mother bitch. Alright, there we go. We made... Fuck you, eggplant monster. Oh my gosh. Alright, back down here. Jeez, that was a pain. Alright, I think we're just gonna keep going down. Alright, no worries. So those things are gonna help us in the boss battle, if you're wondering what we're doing there. Which is just coming up around the corner. Yes, I am getting very angry right now, Eric. I take these retro games very seriously, sir. I don't take no bullshit. Taking it very seriously today. So Rodney says you. Oh boy. Bonesaw, yeah, man, I miss Macho. As I said, next time I stream Street Fighter V, I'll play as Zangief again, because Zangief has got a Macho Man Randy Savage skin, and it's really freaking awesome. He looks just like him. And, he kind of looks like, actually, I don't know if he's supposed to be Macho Man or Jesse Ventura, actually. Because, I remember when, like, Jesse Ventura was kind of wearing that Macho Man getup for, well... You know, what I mean by that is, like, you remember when Jesse Ventura had the bandana and... Actually, come to think of it, the Zangief skin kind of looks a bit more like, Jesse Ventura or Superstar Billy Graham. I don't know why I thought Macho... Yeah, I think it looks a bit more like Superstar Billy Graham or Jesse Ventura, actually. But either way, I'll show you the skin next time, we do it, and you can let me know what you think anyway. Oh, that's right, of course, Captain BS. I'm so sorry, dude. I completely forgot that school was all over and done with. Forgive me, man. I feel so rude now. So it's off to a different town to start working. So what kind of work are you doing, sir? Alright, so we just need to hit him another 100 times. Heath says, does anyone like Wonder Boy? I don't know. I'm wondering if this will answer your question, Heath. Maybe this will answer your question. One of my prized possessions here. There you go, that might answer your question. It's in such a nice nick, too. I gotta brag about this one. Look how nice the condition of this game is still. It has been really, really, really well looked after. Yes. We'll have to actually play this off the actual console next time. I've got a converter that plays Master System games in widescreen HD off the console. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. I just had to brag about one of my games. Hey, we just got raided by ADD Gamer. Good to see you guys. Thank you for coming in, Dan. How you doing today? Don't forget to check out ADD, guys. You'd already know how awesome he is. But just in case you haven't seen ADD Gamer... Plays classic and current games like us. Really talented sumbish. Mm-hmm. He says, you love the game, man, that would be worth it. Yeah, the Master System games, like, sort of, kind of... You know, Dragon's Trap's worth about $50. There's only a couple Sega Master System games that are worth over $100. That's kind of like the HAL games. Phantasy Star's worth about $120. So that's probably one of the more expensive games. Once you get to the games like Golden Axe Warrior and all that, that's when you get into the hundreds of dollars. But there's not a lot of really expensive Master System games still. They all float around the $30 to $50 mark. Focus is on. Yeah, I was focusing a little bit on that one. Hey, didn't mean to ignore the chat. Alright, we're almost there, guys. When am I going to play that F1 Sega game that I own? When I'm feeling confident in our numbers again. As I said, I've been a little bit panicked because I haven't been doing so well numbers-wise lately. And it makes me a little bit scared to take a risk on a game like that when I don't feel like I've been performing. So when I'm feeling a little bit more confident and cheeky, I'll chuck it on. As I said, there's a constant stress when you're a constant content creator, guys. It's a constant stress. But beforehand, I'm going to be doing NASCAR Heat 5 and Formula 1 2020 anyway, Kev, so... You're going to see plenty of other racing games. No, I love Space Harrier 2. We actually do a long play of Space Harrier 2 on the channel quite often. I can beat Space Harrier 2. We usually do Space Harrier 2 every few months, but if you'd like to see a long play of that, I'll make it happen. I love me Space Harrier. Oh, that was close. I nearly missed it. Music educator. So, Captain BS says, you don't know how the year will go with this pandemic still going on. But you'll take it. Yeah, man, that's all we can do. Hey, bud, just hang in there. I think at the end of the day, you're going to be okay, brother. Everything's going to work out. You know what the positive news is, at least, Captain BS? It can only get better from here. It's not going to get worse. Like, obviously, we'll get more cases and everything. But, you know, we've already kind of adapted to the restrictions and everything. Once they get lifted, life will get better. And, man, we're just going to keep hoping for a vaccine. There's a lot of biotech companies working on a vaccine. Hopefully they'll come up with something in the next 6 months. Then we don't have to worry about this shit anymore, hey? Yellowstone. Someone else was telling me about Yellowstone. Maybe that was you before. No, I feel you, Heath. I'd hold on to it. Oh, I see, Alex. Thank you. Thank you for letting me know, man. I appreciate that. Yeah, it's been, yeah, it's really, really weird. Oh, it's all good. Traditionally, if I didn't tag a game, I'd get even more punished. As I said, when I tag Resident Evil... Or when I play Resident Evil, I do very, very well. But anything else, like, I don't even get any traction on my Mario streams anymore. Not really. Anyway, it's just all about figuring out the system, I guess, eh? So Kevin says, after a day like today, seeing Kid Icarus is a blessing. Thank you, Kevin, for the 100 stars. I hope you're okay, man.
Don't forget to bring a towel.
I can't do my telly voice right now.
Be sure to bring a towel so you don't get all wet.
Thank you, Kevin. I appreciate it. So Alex says it's not just you, bro. It's all the streamers. I think it does depend on the games a little bit. Because, like, as you can see, like, when I play Resident Evil, it blows up. When D-Wayne plays Mortal Kombat, that especially blows up. So, I mean, part of it could be a bug, but I think part of it's game choice as well. I'm not sure. As I said, I'm still trying to figure it out. But I have noticed that all streamers are down. I have noticed that. Maybe Facebook just wants us to pay for reach now. Maybe that's what it is. I'm actually going to be doing some experimenting. And starting from in August, I'm going to allocate a budget for boosts. And we'll start boosting streams a little bit and we'll see how we go. So I'm going to start doing that from August. And yeah. Yeah, that could be it, Alex, too. Hey, go on, Alan. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. So, Patrick, we like to play all Mario titles. We do a lot of Mario 1 hacks. We do Mario 3. We do Mario World. We do New Super Mario Brothers. I did Mario's Odyssey. Mario's Odyssey didn't do so great. I don't usually like to do the 3D Marios. I like the old 2D ones, you know? Oh, that's right. Yellowstone is that big mega volcano that can wipe out the human race, right? That's in, where is it? Washington, didn't you say? So Josh said, thinks a big part of everything right now is a mixer shift. Well, that's gonna play into things, definitely. I mean, we haven't seen how that's gonna work out either. What do they frown on? Sorry, Alex. No, thank you, Cruz. Appreciate you. What do they frown on? Well, what are they frowning on, Alex? I probably missed a really important point. Midwest, okay. Or is it Minnesota? I can't remember where Yellowstone is. Oh, thank you, Cruz. I appreciate that. I'll get back to you soon, brother. Oh, see, I don't share my own streams. No, I don't share any of OneCoin streams. Now, if anyone shares my stream to the OneCoin group, I can't control that. But yeah, I don't share my own stream anymore. Well, actually, yes, I do. Sorry. Okay, I'm going to stop doing that. I only share my own stream out once, and that's to the OneCoin only group. But maybe I can experiment and stop doing that. I've done it before, Captain BS, only a couple times, but a lot of streamers do it. What that basically means is you pay a little bit of money and you go on more news feeds. What really annoys me about that system is A, Facebook's already making enough money off me a month, so I think that's a little bit greedy. And B, YouTube don't make you pay for reach, Twitch don't make you pay for reach. So I do think that's a little bit greedy, quite honestly, but... You know, it is a lot easier to grow on Facebook. That's a flip side of things. All right, here we go. We got this. Hey, Gon, Juan. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. We got Lynn back in the business. Good to see you. Lynn, you've come in at a good time. We have almost beaten Kid Icarus. We only got a few levels left here. Oh, yeah, we've got 3 stages left after this one, and this one's done. Yeah, no, I'll start doing some boosts from, So we used to do boosts. About a year ago, Dwayne and I were doing boosts for about a month. And on certain games, it'd work. So basically, with boosts on Facebook, if you're boosting a trending game, it's just going to make your game trend even harder. So if you're boosting a Mortal Kombat stream that's got 500 people, you're going to get 1,000 plus with a boost. Like, that's just going to go mental viral. But if you're just boosting, say, Kid Icarus... You'll go up from about 78 to 150, you know what I mean? So, the boosts are more worthwhile for growth if you're boosting already trending games. That's one thing I've noticed about boosts. Otherwise, they kind of come across as a waste of money. Aaron, thank you, man. It's dark here in the US. But there's... okay, so there's a chance it can turn into a massive volcano and destroy the US. And probably the whole world with all its ash and everything. I think I've seen a documentary on it. I don't want you guys to explode. I love you guys. Aaron, thank you very much.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Thank you, Aaron. I really appreciate the 100 stars. I really hope that doesn't happen. Oh, so it's in Montana. Gotcha. Thank you, guys. Yes, likes and shares are incredible, as Alex said. Our big goal for this stream is to hit 300 likes, and we are already on 256, which is, amazing, so thank you guys. Oh, me too, Kevin. Dude, I grew up with this game. This was one of the first games I owned. Yeah. Definitely one of the first games I owned, this one. Oh my gosh, you know, I got this, I got Castlevania, I got Legend of Zelda. I was really spoiled. Some awesome memories. Man, now, I tell you what, Legend of Zelda is a game I never get sick of playing. I've probably played that game more than any other game on this channel. Yeah, that's what I heard. I heard the big problem with Yellowstone blowing up is it's going to block out the sun. So, I mean, you could probably survive if you had a year's worth of tin food, it'd eventually clear, but... I don't know, you think it'd block out the sun for decades? Jeez, that's a big deal. That is a big deal. I didn't realize it was going to be that long. You should play Duck Hunt. We could do Duck Hunt with the gun on Nintendo Wii eventually, if you like. I might do Duck Hunt with the gun for you guys as a bonus game tonight. We'll see how we go. Well, let's just see what's in here quickly. Yeah, I love Zelda 1. So yeah, the first two games I got was Super Mario Brothers and Rad Racer. Before I got my Nintendo on my 9th birthday, I was always at my aunt's house on the holidays playing Nintendo there. And I think she sold the Nintendo and gave me all her old Nintendo games. So I got like Castlevania and Kid Icarus and Excitebike and all that kind of awesome stuff, Metroid. And then I eventually went to my aunt's place again for the holidays. She sold the Nintendo because she got the Master System. And yeah, so I used to play Master System on the holidays and I'd go home and play Nintendo. Which way am I supposed to go again? This way, I think. You hate that damn dog. Yeah, we'll do Duck Hunt as a bonus game after... Yeah, hang on, I'm going the wrong way here. My bad. I think we gotta go down this way. I really, really, really need someone to crack my back. My back is just in a lot of... Ugh. Yeah. Yeah. So is someone going to volunteer to crack my back for me? I think we need to go down here and get some health. No, that's not the way. Yeah, I want to do Zelda 2 on the Famicom disc system eventually. Gosh, as I said, only one level left after this. We're honestly almost done. This is going really well. My neck, my back, my hoo-ha, and my... Well, you know what. I tell you what, I wonder if that the lady... What was her name? Kia or whatever her name was? I wonder if her dad ever watched that film clap. You know, film clap. Well, I mean, if she sings that song, she probably has a clap. But, I wonder if her dad ever saw that video clip and was like, daughter, I'm so proud of you. Like, damn, man. Did she bring out any other songs apart from that? By the way, you could still drop that song in the nightclub and the women still go crazy. I think we're just gonna go this way and then we're just gonna go up and around. No, is this, no, that's not it. I think we're gonna go up here one more time. You remember a while back asking if I had Mario Kart 8 for the Wii U? Oh, I appreciate you, Patrick, but that wouldn't work out, my friend, because not enough people in the Sunbish Army own a Wii U, so literally no one would connect up apart from you or me, sorry, bud. No, I don't mean to alienate you, Patrick, it's just unfortunately not a lot of people own a Nintendo Wii U, and it just wouldn't work out, unfortunately. But hopefully we can play some games in the future. I would like to very much. I don't know if we're still supposed to go up or not. Hang on. I think we're going the right way. And then what? We're just going to go across? Okay, no, this is the right way. Jeez, it's been a... Damn it, stop turning into a freaking eggplant. I love these little mages from Final Fantasy. You and your sister saying you realize one of your nieces still has their Wii U? Oh, the regular Wii. Guess which one it is, Ricky, just guess. So, the Wii U, Alex. Well, there you go. Davo says he owns a Wii U as well. Well, you are an exception. The Wii U is a failed system, which is a real shame, because the Wii U's phenomenal, to be honest. I think the Nintendo Wii U is a great console. Back out here we shall go. As I said, only one more level left after this. We're going to be beating this game in less than 10 minutes. Oh, we got that. We didn't get hit by the eggplant monster. There's nothing worse than not constantly having to run to the hospital to get rid of the eggplant spell. Kia was also on a rap show, but was disqualified for using old material in a free... Oh, I see. Jeez, man. Yeah, she's a bit of a trollop, that one. Oh, gosh. Man, I'm feeling really, really hungry again. I'm definitely going to get a snack before I do the late night stream. I don't know if D-Wayne's in here, but I need to give D-Wayne a quick call, too. And I think the boss is just in this next room. There we go, it's all done. Oh, damn. Well, those little munchkins just got beat, didn't they? I'm gonna reload here. I wasn't ready for that. Yeah, they're definitely Nintendo Sound Effects 101, aren't they? Oh, come on, get that sumbish, Rick. You can do it. Jeez, I'm not really doing too good here. You have to shoot him a whole bunch of times. You had to shoot him about 92, 93 times in total, I think. Black Mugen's going to bed. Norris, man, we'll see you, No, I never noticed that either, actually, to be honest, one. That's nothing I noticed either. Alright, we'll get there, guys. All just a patience game here. Oh, some bitch is gonna back me into a corner. I'm lucky he didn't hit me then. Almost got him half dead. Gosh, this boss used to piss me off so much. Seeker is an incredible singer. See, Singer goes on the Facebook stories every day, and she's always got, like, a new song to sing. It's actually incredible how many songs you know how to sing. You should totally do a YouTube where you just do snippets of songs every day, Seeker. You'd do really, really well, I think. Have you ever thought about going on YouTube? You've definitely got the persona for it. You're playing Combat League to get to Demigod. Oh, no, that's okay. If you're streaming, I'll call you later. I just wanted to call you quickly about what we were talking about before. But it's no rush. If you're streaming, I'll get to you afterwards. Okay. Okay, I've got one more health container here if I need it. We only need to shoot him about another 12 times. We do have a health potion here, so it's not... I'll about 10 minutes. Alright, one more hit. Oh my gosh, I was fatiguing big time on that boss. Oh man, I need some sugar. I really need some sugar, guys. Ah, good. Hey. Here we go, guys. This is the very last level, and this one only takes 5 minutes. And there's a glitch at the final boss, which makes it very easy to beat. Now, this is probably one of the most fun levels in the game, and you only get to do it once. You got these little characters in here from Metroid 2. I love the music in this final level too, how good is it? So it looks like, you know, we're no longer a fallen angel, we've gotten our wings back and we're in heaven and... Well, I mean, whatever the Greek version of heaven is. Hey, that's Sylvester! What the hell is Sylvester doing in this game? That was totally out of place. What the fuck, Sylvester? Looney Tunes just called, they want their character back. What the hell is Sylvester doing in this? We got like the Venus Del Milo back in the background. There you go, look guys, boobs. We got 8-bit boobs. No, I'm just having water. I've just got a bottle of water here at the moment, just trying to stay hydrated. I had a couple beers last night, so I'm trying to stay hydrated. When I say couple, I literally only had 2 beers, but they still dehydrate me. £5 to £10. Oh, Alex, dude, that's going to cost about $100+, dude. The postage is going to cost a lot more than what the items in the care package cost. That's a lot of money. And you know, it's expensive. Very nice, tasteful. There you go. So you have, what you have to do is you need to loop this level twice. Okay, we do have a bonus health if we need it. So Alex says, did I ever try your hangover cure? Oh no, because I've not had a hangover since you mentioned it. I'm not hungover at all. As I said, I only had 2 beers. Jeez, man. Like, I'm a little bit of a Cadbury, but not that much. I was actually thinking of buying a backwards compatible PS3 just for the convenience, but I don't know. Has anyone got a backwards compatible PS? If you've got a backwards compatible PS3, let me know. What does the quality of PS2 and PS3 one games play like? Like, is it worth it, or do you think it's not worth picking one up? Because I was thinking of picking one up. I think we're almost up to this boss. Brussels sprouts are good for hangovers. I did not know that. We've almost... Thank you once again so much for watching. One more time, guys. Don't forget to like the stream. As I said, 300 likes are the goal. We are almost there. And, here we go. This is the final boss now. Oh gosh. Come, we'll get him. Damn. We had a health potion left, luckily. You can play, that's right, you could play iToy on the PS3. That's pretty interesting. I haven't seen the trailer yet, but I know it's coming out. I just don't know what the release date is. It took me so long to get past the first stage. You're not alone. There we go. Way to go, Pit. Get lost, Pit. Oh, why are you so rude? He just saved you. How can you talk to him like that? He just saved you. Now he's putting on a stupid hat. He looks like freaking Crocodile Dundee now by Cracky. Pit's put on his Crocodile Dundee hat. And let's see what Princess Palutena or whatever her freaking name is. By the way, I've got the Palutena and Pit amiibos here because I love this game so much. Well, there you go. Pit became a... Oh, that's no good. What a horrible, horrible ending that was. Oh my gosh, what a game. Guys, I really, really appreciate you. I'm going to go back to the main screen now. And thank you all very, very, very much for watching, guys. I really appreciate you all coming in. We did Kid Icarus and Simon's Quest. We had a pretty successful day. D-Wayne also did some Mortal Kombat. Guys, I'm going to have about an hour break. And I'm going to come back on very, very soon for the late night. So if you're going to bed, have a great sleep. But if you're still awake... we will be back on one. Thank you very much. One with 150 stars. This is for you. But thank you again for all the likes, the shares, and star donations. As always, guys, you're incredible. And hang tight in the chat, guys. I am going to send you all into another stream. So I will see you guys in an hour. Take care. And there you go, trying to find an inspirational thing to say to sign off, but I've got nothing, so I'm just going to leave now. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye.